A lot of people thinking about De'Aaron Fox right now. Look, I'm not going to have you complain all show, okay? If you want to get it out of your system, I'll give you 30 seconds right now, and then we move on.
Can I save it for when it gets hotter later? Because it's going to get hotter later.
It's actually not that bad.
I'm going to sweat right through this shirt, dude.
Well, that's
gray. Gray was a bad choice. I should have gone with a dark color because it's going to show.
That is a
you
problem.
Right now, it is going to show.
We have a nice little breeze underneath the tent that we're sitting under.
Yeah, it's not too bad right now. I'll say that.
It's not too bad.
I'm not sweating right now. I'm more just glazed than sweating, you know?
You done? That's your 30 seconds. You shut off for the rest of the show now. So let's get into De'Aaron Fox as we get you ready for game five on this Wednesday. So we go back to Monday, Ramie. Monday we find out an avulsion fracture of the index finger at the tip of the shooting hand there of De'Aaron Fox. And we immediately think this isn't great. This isn't even good. Who knows if he's going to play?
Everybody wants to play. Yeah.
I don't think everybody was panicking, but I think,
panicked a little. I'm not going to lie. I'll admit it. I panicked a little bit.
I think that's because you just have a sunny disposition during the show most of the time. That's how I feel about that. And so when you get a little bit, it comes across as panic.
That might be fair.
I thought you were okay. I was okay. But we were concerned about De'Aaron Fox, his future in this series, whether or not he would play tonight. Then yesterday, we hear from Fox himself, right? He says, I'm 99 to 100% sure I'm going to play. I feel pretty good. Frankie Cardicelli's tweeting, telling us that the spirits were good from De'Aaron Fox during the non-contact shoot-around yesterday. So we started to feel pretty good about De'Aaron Fox playing tonight. And then we get to today. But before we get to today's news and some of the stories that are out there, let's first hear from Fox's teammate, Domantas Sabonis, on the injury.
Doctors don't really know exactly how similar the injuries are, but I just know he's going to play. Thanks to him, we're playing. We're getting this game, so I'm happy he's playing. That's all that matters.
I just know he's going to play. I'm not a doctor. I don't know about the similarities between my injury and his injury, but he's going to play. That's all I care about. Then we're reading in The Athletic today. Friend Sam Amick of Sactown Sports writes the following. Anyone who watched Fox closely during his post-practice shooting session could see that there was occasional pain. He would grimace on some free throws and even let out an F-bomb after one particularly frustrating miss. So we've got that from Sam Amick saying that De'Aaron Fox looked uncomfortable. He's cursing. He's frustrated and all that stuff. Then I see on Twitter today, multiple local guys on TV and writers, multiple local guys telling us, De'Aaron looks great. The shot doesn't look like it's bothered at all. He looks like he's ready to play 45 minutes. Everybody's pumped. And then we hear from Fox himself again. And here was Fox talking about, I guess I'd call it an incident recently after this injury in his car.
I mean, just everyday life, like I'm fine, you know. I actually hit it on the steering wheel yesterday. like if I'm just sitting here, like I don't feel it, it's fine. And I went to put my hand, and I actually hit the spot that actually is where the bone chipped, and they it hurt yesterday.
You get hit on it. You play, right? In a game of basketball.
I expected to get hit, but I mean, at this point during the season, something hurts anyway. So, I mean, you play through the pain. There's no excuses coming from this way.
I don't know who asked that follow-up question. I don't know if it was Deuce. It sounded like Deuce, but I'm not sure if it was him or not. But it was a fantastic follow-up. When you hear De'Aaron Fox mm-hmm. say, I bumped my finger on my steering wheel, and I felt it, and it bothered me, and he's cursing about how much it hurt, the follow-up question is, hey, De'Aaron, you're playing in a basketball game this week. You're going to get hit in that hand. How's it going to feel? That doesn't necessarily make you feel super optimistic about his ability to play through contact.
And – first of all, why is this man not wrapped in bubble wrap every minute between games 4 and 5?
What are we doing? Why is he even driving?
Why is his finger even exposed?
Get
to
this
hit
man a
the
driver.
Steering wheel, or at least like wrap his hand in some. I saw John Morant the other day, and they had his hand in like a fort. You know what I mean? They were not messing around with that thing. I don't know why De'Aaron Fox is walking around with his hand just totally unprotected with a broken finger. And when he says. And, Nick, I know you said not to do this the other day. I'm not going to do what you're going to think I'm about to do. When he says, like, everything hurts these days, I don't know if you've ever – have you ever had a broken bone on your hand at all? Have you ever had that?
No.
Okay, I have. And I know exactly the pain that he's talking about when it comes to just something as simple as bumping it against a steering wheel. And I mean, I'm not an NBA player, so I don't know how much stuff hurts by the end of the season. But I know for me, that pain of just bumping your a broken bone in your hand into something, it's like it's stop you in your tracks pain. You know what I mean? Like the type of thing where you do it and you stop immediately and you have to like shake it off and take a breath before you can go back on to what you were doing. So hearing him describe it that well, tell that story and then describe it that way, I don't feel as good as I felt yesterday. And throw in, you know, the grimacing. We asked for a wins count on the show yesterday. Nobody gave us a wins count. Apparently Sam Amick was the only guy listening and telling us that there was some grimacing. And he screamed an expletive at the free throw line at one point. I went from feeling like terrible about the whole thing a couple days ago to feeling pretty good about it yesterday to now probably like, I don't know, somewhere in between and not really knowing what to think about this whole injury. But I can tell you I don't feel as good as I did 24 hours ago with the news that he was going to play or 99 to 100% chance he was going to play.
Cattles and Ramie on a Wednesday, Sactown Sports. Here's more from Fox talking about handling the basketball with this injury.
Oh, the ball handling action was fine. Like, as soon as I got out, dribbling and passing was fine. So for me, the most important thing was could I shoot as pain-free as possible.
I mean, I know you just said you don't really know how to feel. You're kind of in the middle. I know how I'm feeling right now, to quote my guy Anchorman. I remember this.
Ah! Oh, I'm in a glass case of emotion.
Yeah. Yeah, that's how I feel.
Yeah, that's a good way to sum it up.
That's how I feel. On Monday, there was concern. Yesterday, it's like, okay, I'm feeling pretty good about this. I'm pretty optimistic about this. And then I hear De'Aaron talk about hitting his hand and some of the questions and all of that stuff. And I read Sam Amick. I don't know what to believe, man. I don't know how to feel. I'm all over the place. My emotions are high. They're low. They're tough to control. And I guess I just go back to my message from Monday when we first heard about this injury. And my message was, we have no idea what to expect. We should not anticipate any kind of level of play. If he gives you 75% tonight, you should be happy with that. Is he going to be himself, Ramie? It's very unlikely. It's very unlikely that we see De'Aaron Fox play tonight and he looks like the guy that we've seen the first four games of this series. It's unlikely because he's hurt. He's not the same. His shooting hand has been hurt. That's going to affect him. There's no doubt it's going to affect him when he's handling the basketball from time to time. It's going to affect him when he's trying to dribble, especially through traffic. It's going to impact him if he's trying to defend and just knocks the ball away. Every little thing, like you mentioned, every little thing when you have an injury like this, it's going to bug you. I don't know if he's going to be 70%, 80%, 60%, but I would not anticipate him or expect him to be the same guy he was 1-4.
He will have the benefit of adrenaline and painkillers too. And that's a powerful thing, Nick. I'm being a great athlete myself. I broke my hand in the first game of a flag football doubleheader. I finished the whole thing.
I got
two interceptions, man. You know what I mean?
What are we doing?
What?
You're complaining about the weather. You're telling us flag football stories or whatever the hell's
going
on. Two
interceptions with a broken hand, dude. God. I'm just saying. It was an impressive performance.
Didn't you just say moments ago, I'm not going to do what you said that people shouldn't do in this situation? No, you didn't do it in that moment. You did it 5 minutes later. Ladies and gentlemen, Ramie. Cole G says, I've broken my hand twice. First time I didn't know for 3 days.
I didn't know until the next day.
Everybody's reaction is different. Everybody's body reacts differently. Everybody's pain tolerance is different. So we don't know. Domas has played with an avulsion fracture all year long. As I've said before, it was on his non-shooting hand, his non-dribbling hand, but he's played all year long. So again, we don't know what the expectations should be tonight. I would just say don't think too high. And let's see how he plays. Don't walk into this game feeling like the world is over, that the world has ended. Don't walk into this game thinking that, oh, man, they can't win because De'Aaron Fox is banged up. Let's see how he looks. But obviously when he says that he hit it on the steering wheel and he felt uncomfortable, I think it's rather logical and really commonsensical to imagine there's going to be a point in tonight's game where he's going to hit that hand and he's going to feel it. He's going to shake it. He might have to go to the bench. Just kind of mentally prepare that.
And
you know,
and everybody watching is going to go, everybody's going to gasp and stop breathing collectively until you see him get back to action. I hate this feeling, Nick. I really hate this feeling. Why can't life be easy? You know what I mean? Why can't we just have 7-game series or 6-game series, just healthy players, good basketball? Why does life got to be hard, Nick?
Life's not perfect.
Why does life have to be hard?
Life is not perfect. 916-339-1140 is the text line. The phone number is 1-800-920-1140. That's the latest on De'Aaron Fox. We want your thoughts on Fox. We want your thoughts on this gigantic Game 5 tonight. Warriors, Kings, we're live from DOCO getting you ready. Don't forget to swing by the YouTube channel, youtube.com/SactownSports1140, and give us that thumbs up while you're there. We always appreciate
Baby Yoda
the likes.
Here, right over your shoulder?
Yes, Baby Yoda, of course, shoulder. Is in the house. Baby Yoda does not have his Fox t-shirt, though, today.
Why can't we get this thing together? Now she forgot the shirt.
Why can't we travel and keep this thing together? Every time it's something with Baby Yoda.
Road games, man. We're like the Warriors. We're like the Warriors on the road. We can't get it quite right.
We can't figure it out.
The little things, you know? We can't do the little things on the road.
Home games, we feel good.
Oh, we crush it. At home, we can't be stopped.
We got his hat going, but we get on the road and all hell breaks loose. All right, Want your thoughts on Fox. Want your thoughts on Game 5 tonight. Warriors Kings also in 90 seconds. Can the Kings rely on HB?
Cattles
and Rami.
Sactown Sports. Sactown Sports wants to congratulate Kings head coach Mike Brown for being the first coach to unanimously win the NBA Coach of the Year Award.
100 first place votes. First time ever.
Wow.
A unanimous decision.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, everybody. I'm really appreciative of being in Sacramento. The fans, city has been fantastic.
How will Coach Brown lead the Kings during the playoffs?
Tune into Sactown Sports and SactownSports.com to find out.
Wendy's $3 breakfast deal is a bacon or sausage egg croissant plus small seasoned potatoes for $3. It's the breakfast that don't miss. So if you did miss Wendy's breakfast, don't imagine. Fresh cracked eggs, sizzling sausage, crispy bacon, and block out those hot, buttery, flaky croissants. Croissants don't really make a sound, but if they did... For a breakfast that don't miss, Wendy's is that breakfast. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's $3 breakfast deal.
Limited time only. Participating U.S. Wendy's. Select a request $3 breakfast deal to obtain discount. Not valid for a la carte or combo orders.
When you take the time to shop at Folsom Lake Honda, there's one thing you'll always find. Happy people ready to serve you. As a family-owned and operated dealership since 2009, customer service is our number one priority. Our customers love doing business with us, and you will too.
Looking to own or lease? During the spring sales event, drive a brand new Accord or Civic. Visit us today at FolsomLakeHonda.com, your one-stop Honda shop.
Folsom Lake Honda, yeah, your one-stop Honda shop.
One brings Makloff magic, while the other, we're still trying to figure that out.
Cattles and Ramie.
Sactown Sports.
If you're wondering what the official count of Rami has derailed the show is, we're already at two. Two. Within 9 minutes, twice. Within 30 seconds, once, and then circled back at the end to make sure that he could derail it towards the end of the segment as well, which led to Mr. All Red Everything in the YouTube chat commenting, Rami Bundy with the flag football stories.
Has scored 4 touchdowns in one game.
Rami had 2 interceptions with a broken hand.
A broken hand, ladies and gentlemen.
Supposedly.
Played a doubleheader.
I don't know if we have documented video on this.
Before halftime of the first game.
We cannot confirm nor deny this story by Rami. He could be making this up completely.
100% sure, I'll swear, on a stack of Bibles right now.
Ward also commented in the YouTube chat, this whole time I wondered if it was Rami's great sports takes or his comedy that his girlfriend was with him, only to just learn it was his flag football career. That was the clincher for Emily.
Yep.
We were talking about De'Aaron Fox and Sam Amick in The Athletic writing that Fox visibly looked frustrated yesterday after the no contact practice that they had. And at one point, he screamed an F-bomb when he missed a shot. MC says in the YouTube chat, I yell F-bombs when I miss the toilet. So he's not too concerned,
I guess. Why are you missing the toilet, dude? I don't understand that. I don't want to derail the show again. Yeah, it's a huge target.
See, just then, just stop there.
It's a huge target.
You see, your first thought is, I don't want to derail the show. Period. End of sentence.
I can't respond to the commenter? That's why they comment.
Push
a little interaction.
Power through, Ramie.
Huge target,
power
guys,
through.
Is all I'm saying.
TCG, it's game day, homies. Let's go. Yes, it is. And Scooter916 in the YouTube chat says, forget Baby Yoda. Give the thumbs up for Simone in the background.
Hey.
And people know that they just continue to absolutely grow the ego of Simone exponentially day by day.
Nobody's delivered her coffee out here yet today. So
Not yet.
If there are any volunteers out there in YouTube land.
It's really early. It's really early. Give it time.
It's time.
Give it time.
Lots of ball game left here, folks.
Yeah. Something will be brought to Simone before the end of the show. It will be hand-delivered, maybe with a bow on it. It's going to happen. All right, so your thoughts on Fox, if you have them, your thoughts on this series, your thoughts on Game 5, 916-339-1140. Of course, the phone number always open for you at 1-800-920-1140. But, Ramie, I wanted to spend a couple of minutes talking about HB here. In this series, he's averaging 13 points a game. He's shooting 42% from the floor, 25% from three. Did Coach Brown give HB a pep talk? Here's Coach.
No, I mean, he's a veteran. He doesn't need that. I'm sure his wife probably did, you know, or probably did, but he doesn't need that game.
Yeah, maybe his wife gave him the pep talk. I'm not giving him the pep talk. Ramie, can we rely on Harrison Barnes?
Some of the career playoff numbers may indicate that you can't rely too much on him, Nick. I have seen moments in this series where the Kings needed plays, and Harrison Barnes will come up with the plays, whether it's a basket to stop a Warriors run, a defensive stop, a smart pass, in crucial moments of the game. I think you can still depend on Harrison Barnes in those times, but his career playoff numbers don't do a lot to impress you or instill a lot of confidence that you can count on this guy to come out night in, night out, and produce a good stat line for you.
Yeah, those career playoff numbers that Rami's mentioning, it doesn't scream offensive force to you. In the playoffs, HB in his career, he's averaged 11 points. He scores 11 points a night in the postseason. And his shooting percentages are much lower than you would expect. I mean, he shoots 42% from the floor, which is exactly what he's doing right now in this series. Now, he does shoot the three ball better than he shot in this series so far. Throughout his playoff career, HB has shot...
That's the part that concerns you right there.
Yeah, throughout his playoff career, HB has shot 34.6% from three. And I think some of these things, you know, some of his lackadaisical play, his mediocre play, his average play, however you want to put the adjective to it, get to the free throw line. That's the first thing I would say to HB. Get to the free throw line. I want to see him pick up his aggressiveness tonight in this game. Get to the free throw line. He's averaging just over three free throws a game. That's not nearly enough. Like, one of the things about HB that he helps the most with this offense is that he gets to the bucket, he gets to the line. When you look at Fox, you look at Monk, you look at Barnes, those are the three guys that you count on with driving to the bucket, attacking the rim, and trying to get to the free throw line. And so when Barnes is averaging 3.25 free throws a game, that tells me he's not going to the bucket enough. In the regular season, Ramie, he averaged 5 free throws a game. And that might not sound significant, but over an 82-game sample size, 5 free throws versus 3.25 over a 4-game sample size, that is a significant difference. Like, you know,
you're talking about, I mean, over 7 games, Nick. Give me the averages again. I'm going to do some quick radio math for you. Give me those averages. So in the regular season, he was getting in line 5 times a game?
Yes.
Playoffs 3.5 times a game?
3.25.
Over the course of 7 games, we're talking about almost 8 free throw shots total. 8 points could be the difference in this series. With how close it's been to this point, 8 free throws could be the difference in this series. I'm sure my math was wrong.
It was totally wrong.
Okay.
It's fine. But you
get my point.
So just,
the margins are slim.
Just go to the bucket,
man. I should have just said that.
I would love to see in this first quarter Harrison Barnes gets the basketball within the first couple of possessions and attacks the basket.
10.5.
Just goes after the rim.
10.5.
Just attacks the rim. That's all he has to do. Early in this game, set the tone and attack the rim. I think he is more than capable of doing that. And I'd also say this. Golden State likes to switch. At times, they love to switch. You know what, HB? If they switch and you have an advantage,
take it.
Take advantage of that advantage. Mm-hmm. Whether you take somebody to the bucket, you back them down, and you get them into the paint, take advantage of those switches. Get to the bucket, take advantage of the switches. That's what HB, I think, has to do. Getting out in transition would also help. Some easy buckets for him. And on the defensive end, look, just defend and rebound. Defend and rebound. Make sure you keep the Warriors off the offensive glass as much as you can. And that's what you're looking for. I don't anticipate HB shooting 50% from the floor and 40% from three because he's never done it in the postseason. If he does it, fantastic. But the least he can do is get to the free throw line, take advantage of switches, get out in transition, defend and rebound.
Like I said, though, he has come up with some of those key plays. You know what I mean? Like those low-key plays where he grabs a rebound or makes a big shot. He's done a few things in big spots in this series where I don't know that the Kings win games if he doesn't do them. But like I said, Nick, on a consistent play in, play out, night in, night out basis, he just and it's a big enough sample size from his time with the Warriors. He just hasn't been that guy in the playoffs, and I don't know that you're going to necessarily see that guy at any point.
So if you want to rely on HB. I would be somewhat hesitant to say, oh, he's going to take over a game. It's possible. But again, he just has not necessarily been that guy in his career in the postseason. I want to remind you, first-round playoff coverage on Sactown Sports is brought to you by National Garage Door. National Garage Door, quality doors, quality people. We have 42 likes on the YouTube channel. Let's get it to 50. Can we get that to 50? By 2:30. Let's try to get to 50 likes by 2:30.
I bet if we could get that dog in the onesie who was wearing sunglasses on camera, 100 likes. 100 likes. That's what I was pointing at, Simone.
Yes.
There was a dog in a onesie wearing sunglasses.
No doubt about that. Tons of likes for the dog in the onesie. But continue to give us those likes. We appreciate it. More likes, more eyeballs. And, of course, we're growing the brand here 6A to 6P Monday through Friday, live and local, covering the Kings better than anybody else in Sacramento. Sean Powell from NBA.com will join us next.
Cattles
and Rami.
Sactown Sports.
Power Business Technology is proud to be 100% independent, locally owned, and managed Toshiba copier dealer. Local ownership cuts out the red tape, allowing ourselves to never be too busy to personally answer the call when our clients need us. Recognized for excellence in service execution, training, and customer service, we're proud to be named a 2022 Toshiba ProMasters Elite Dealer. Contact us today for all of your business printing needs at 844-POWER-BC. That's 844-769-3729, or visit us at powercopiers.com. At the Gonzalez Law Office, we focus on trials and litigation to achieve the best result. For over a decade, Jonathan Gonzalez has conducted more than 60 jury trials to verdict, and since 2016, has only lost two. We understand how to fight for our clients and make sure our clients get the best results. We don't settle for less, and neither should you. Call us to handle all your criminal and injury cases. 916-304-9187. That's 916-304-9187. Or visit us at sacklegaldefense.com.
Kevin Lewis of National Garage Door. Whether you need to repair a broken spring, install a new opener, or buy a quality Rainer door, National Garage Door is here for you. Call us today to see how we can transform your house with a new garage door.
638-4554 National Garage Door.
Hey Sacramento, while you're watching the playoffs, don't get stuck on the bench in a warm house. Fox Family Heating and Air can get you cooling fast with most parts backed by a lifetime warranty.
Fox Family Heating and Air.
At Elk Grove Honda, we'd like to help you purchase your next new Honda. Right now at Elk Grove Honda, new Hondas are arriving on a regular basis, including the newly designed CR-V, new design Accords, exciting Civics, and much more. And Elk Grove Honda's pre-owned inventory offers choices there as well. So give Elk Grove Honda a chance to show you the new or pre-owned Honda you're looking for. We are Elk Grove Honda in the Elk Grove Auto Mall, Highway 99 at Elk Grove Boulevard, or visit us at ElkGroveHonda.com.
I gotta get an Elk Grove Honda Honda.
Jiffy Lube's Country in the Park, Northern California's biggest country music festival of the year, is back May 5th and 6th at Cal Expo, starring Lady A,
Chris Young,
I shouldn't be halfway home, but oh no.
Burt Eldridge.
I want to be that song.
And so many more.
Plus, at least the Inline Dance Saloon, Interactive Lounges, and Sacramento's best food trucks. Weekend passes start at just $80. Tickets are on sale now at SactownSports.com. Country in the Park, brought to you by Cache Creek Casino Resort, Hanley's Western Wear, and Quick Hot Car Wash.
Guys, did you know your testosterone affects everything in your system, including how you feel and perform every day? Right now, Revive Men's Health Sacramento will check your testosterone for free. Knowing your T levels is the first step in understanding if you have low T. Your testosterone level impacts your energy, libido, sleep, weight, hair loss, mood, and even ED. Maintaining an appropriate T level can change your whole life. Most men start to see changes in their hormone levels in their 30s. Experience and results matter. So what are you waiting for? Get your T-levels checked today by local, experienced, and trusted men's health experts. They've helped thousands of men since 2011. They're so confident they can help you, they even guarantee it. Call Revive today and schedule your free testosterone test, free exam, and free consultation. Call Revive Men's Health at 916-277-8599. That's 916-277-8599. Or visit RevivemensHealth.com.
Great team. Where's the defense? Defense! Okay, everyone take a break. Greetings, Sacramento. Doug Christie here for the Good Feet Store, asking when is something too good to be true? When it probably is, and had I not experienced it for myself, this spectacular season would definitely qualify as too good to be true. So everyone out there in radio land, continue to enjoy. Something else that could seem too good to be true is Good Feet Arch Supports. But trust me, I've experienced firsthand the comfort, balance, and support possible with Good Feet Arch Supports. And so have countless others who have pretty much given up hope. It's time you felt good again. Take your feet to the Good Feet Store for free personalized arch support fitting and test walk. Experience for yourself the comfort, balance, and support missing in your life. The Good Feet Store in Sacramento, Roseville, Stockton, Modesto, and now Vacaville. Online at goodfeet.com.
Sactown Sports
Headlines.
It's Simone with your Sactown Sports Headlines. Sacramento Kings get ready for a crucial Game 5 matchup tonight with the Golden State Warriors at Golden 1 Center. Of course, the series remains tied 2-2 as both teams thus far have taken care of business on the home court. The big headline, of course, has been the precarious status of De'Aaron Fox and his fractured index finger on his left shooting hand. We will keep you updated on his status and preview this exciting matchup all afternoon, reporting live outside of G1C, leading you up to game night coverage beginning at 5:30 and tip-off slated for 7 right here on Sactown Sports or on our Sactown Sports app. I'm Simone. Those are your Sactown Sports headlines. Nate, let's toss it down to Cattles and Ramie.
Your afternoon home for Kings talk and more.
This is Cattles and Ramie
on Sactown Sports.
All right, lots of basketball to talk about, discuss here on Sactown Sports. Cattles and Ramie on a hump day. And right now, joining us on the Folsom Lake Honda Hotline, Folsom Lake Honda, your one-stop Honda shop, is Sean Powell from NBA.com. Sean, thank you for joining us. It is very much appreciated. Let's start with the obvious first question tonight as we sit here at DOCO outside of the G1C. How would you handicap the chances of the Kings for this series to win this series without a better than, let's say, 75% De'Aaron Fox?
I would say that they don't have much of a chance at all. Fox has been by far the best player for the Kings in this series. Also consider, in this series, you look at Sabonis, Harrison Barnes, Kevin Herter, and Murray. All four of those players, the playoff performance is down from the regular season in some way, shape, or form. And I think that that really hurts Sacramento. When you really look at that stat and that reality, in a sense, they're kind of fortunate to be tied 2-2.
As you watch this series, and you pointed out the difficulties that Domas has had among those other guys, but do you get the sense that it's something that the Warriors are doing to give him those problems? Or do you think, Domas, this is a lot of self-inflicted pain over the course of this series?
I think it's more self-conflicted. If you never saw this guy play, you would have swore he was born without a right hand, and he doesn't know how to shoot a mid-range shot, because they're giving him that shot. And until the last game, he took a few jumpers. But for what reason is he not taking that open shot? And I'm confused by that. The other thing is, does a guy ever go to his right? I mean, he's fake like you're going to go to your right. He's always going left. They know he's going left. They're playing him to the left, and he's making a lot of mistakes and drawing offensive fouls by trying to bull his way to the rim. I just don't understand the way he's playing now versus the way he played in the regular season. This is a guy who could make all NBA this year. But if you just saw him on this playoff series, you'd be like, what? Seriously? He's a much better player than what he's shown in this series.
Sean Powell from NBA.com is with us here. Cattles and Ramie, Sactown Sports. Sean, is there anything that you see that the coaching staff could do to maybe open up Domas a little bit more?
I mean, look, you can just tell him what he needs to do, but that's really about a confidence. It's a lack of confidence when you don't make an open jumper. They're giving you the 15-footer. It's a lack of confidence. What are the coaches going to tell him? Take the shot? I mean, it's not a complicated game. So I just think with him, it's just a lack of confidence right now, particularly going to his right. These things are just so very apparent. A coach should not have to tell you to do these things. That's why I'm really confused. Look, this guy is a solid player, fantastic rebounder. Like I said, one of the better young frontline players in the NBA. But for whatever reason, and I don't know if he's in the fog, and I don't know if it's because of the postseason. I don't know if he feels pressure. I don't know what it is, and I'm not trying to put all the blame on him. Like I said, Harrison Barnes hasn't really stepped. Kevin Herter hasn't hit that long-range jump shot, so it's just not on Sabonis. But I just feel that we just really haven't seen the best of Sabonis so far in this series. And there's still time, but we haven't seen it yet.
After De'Aaron Fox and wondering if his hand will allow him to keep playing at the level that he is, and after wondering if Domas will figure out what's given him problems throughout the series, who's the next most important guy on this Kings roster that you think needs to wake up and get things going?
Well, I would maybe Herter, only because he was such a revelation for them this year, getting him from Atlanta, and he stepped right in. He has been very consistent. Big part of the Kings, offense, historically great offense. Same thing with Murray, of course. But Murray's a rookie, so I'm kind of giving him a little bit of a pass for
sure.
Being in a little bit of slump. And he sort of broke out of it the last game. But I would say they definitely heard it. Harrison Barnes, again, this is a guy who has, deep playoff experience. I thought we would probably see a little bit better from him, missing that, that last shot. Last game, he had a chance to win it for Sacramento. Hopefully that doesn't follow him to the next game. He seems to be a very even-keel guy. I don't think it will. But you would like to think that the Sacramento Kings, when they see that, De'Aaron Fox, who, by the way, has just been tremendous, tremendous. If you never watched the Sacramento Kings this year, and you see De'Aaron Fox, you're like, where's this guy been? No, he's been there all year. You just haven't watched him. So he's been a terrific player for them. But now that he's handicapped to an extent, you would like to think that some of these players who are slumping, Sabonis goes from shooting 61% in the regular season down to 48% in playoffs, averaging 4 turnovers in the playoffs. You would think that one of these 4 players that I mentioned would step up. And by the way, we should mention Davion's defense, which I think has been a hidden gem for Sacramento this series. This young kid is just really on the ball. Look, who's going to stop Steph Curry? No one's going to stop him. But Davion Mitchell has played very well for them off the bench.
Sean Powell's with us on the Folsom Lake Honda Hotline. Folsom Lake Honda, your one-stop Honda shop. Sean, the Celtics continue to struggle to close games out in the postseason. It happened again last night. The Bucks are on the brink of elimination against the Heat. Joel Embiid is injured. Who makes the most sense for you coming out of the East at this point?
Man, that's a great question right now. I think if you asked that question just, 4 days ago, I'd still say the Milwaukee Bucks. And maybe so. I mean, they're down 3-1. Of all the teams that are down 3-1 playing tonight, you would think that Milwaukee probably still has the best chance of returning that series and winning and moving on. Now, in the history of the NBA best of seven series, the teams that go up 3-1, they win 95% of the time. So that stat is against Milwaukee. But Bucks are back home. I think Giannis is going to rise to the occasion. And if the Bucks win, then it's about going back to Miami. So, look, I think Boston is just a momentary stumble. I think they'll be okay in the series against Atlanta. And Philadelphia, look, I mean, the bottom line is with Philadelphia, they brought themselves a few more, or Atlanta, by beating Boston. But Joel Embiid, a few more games where he can get healthy. So we'll see how he plays the game one of the, you know, the conference semifinals, and see whether or not that injury is going to affect him or not.
Is it any easier to pick who's coming out of the West?
No. I mean, look, this, the entire NBA right now is just a toss-up. You know, before the playoffs, you said, okay, Milwaukee looks pretty good coming out of the East for sure, but I think that's been clouded a little bit. In the West, I mean, I don't know, man. When the playoffs began, if you looked at the top three teams in the West, you know, you would say, well, they're a lot shaky. Memphis, Sacramento, Denver, none of those teams have been to the promised land before in recent history. So you figure that the next tier, you know, the Warriors, the Lakers, a healthy Lakers, rejuvenated Lakers team, LeBron and AD, maybe they would probably have the best shot. And also the Phoenix Suns getting Kevin Durant mid-season, and now all of a sudden they're the favorite. So it's really confusing. We really don't know. My hunch says Denver will make it through, but I would not be surprised if one of these so-called lower seeds, and that is Phoenix, the Warriors, the Lakers, pull a surprise and make it out of the West.
Last one for you, Sean, and again, we thank you for your time today. Of course, the Clippers were eliminated last night. Is it time for some big changes this offseason?
Well, they don't really have much to deal. I mean, most of their draft capital is gone. It belongs to the Oklahoma City Thunder for the Paul George trade. And if you look up and down that roster, I'm not so sure they have assets that can really get something other than Kawhi Leonard, obviously, and Paul George. So really the question comes down to, do you trade one of those two players? Also complicating things is they have a new arena opening up in about a year and a half. And I don't think Steve Ballmer wants to bring a rebuilding team into that the Intuit Dome when it opens. So that kind of complicates matters a little bit. And that's where he might tell his management, hey, you know what? Let's ride and dive with Paul George and Kawhi Leonard at least through the first year of that arena. I don't want to bring a losing team, but rebuilding team in there. And we don't have the draft capital either to have the number one pick or anything. It belongs to Oklahoma City. I think they're going to stick with the status quo. They'll probably bring back Russell Westbrook and give it another try. Keep in mind, by the way, when Paul George and Kawhi Leonard are healthy, that's a dangerous team. I don't know if they've even lost a playoff game when they're on the floor together and healthy, or playoff series, I should say. So I think they're going to run it back. They're just going to keep their fingers crossed one more year.
Sean, great stuff, man. We appreciate you. Thanks for doing this, and hopefully we catch up again soon.
Sounds good.
There goes Sean Powell, NBA.com. He was on the Folsom Lake Honda hotline. Folsom Lake Honda, your one-stop Honda shop. It was a fantastic point about the arena and how that might shape the Clippers offseason.
That's true.
It's really good stuff from Sean Powell. We'll continue thoughts
all
on
toilets.
Kings.
Remember all the toilets in
yes.
the arena?
Yes. I would scream, but it's not as good when you're on the headset because it'll just get distorted. If I was in the studio, I'd scream toilets right now, but it wouldn't do well here. We'll continue with your thoughts. Warriors, Kings, Game 5 tonight here from the G1C. Cattles and Rami live from DOCO. Come on by. Say hello. Check us out on YouTube as well. YouTube.com, Sactown Sports, 1140. We'll keep it moving next.
Cattles and Rami.
Sactown Sports. Sactown Sports is Sacramento's new home for the San Francisco 49ers.
It feels awesome. We deserve this. Let's go, Niners!
Purdy.
Purdy gonna throw, and it is Kittle in the back of the end zone.
Samuel.
Debo 10. Debo. Touchdown!
And McCaffrey.
Touchdown!
They all live here on Sactown Sports.
Your official home for 49ers football.
Get to Acura of Stockton, where precision-crafted performance is at your fingertips. Elevate your driving experience with a vehicle that's built to impress. Acura of Stockton has a great selection of new Acuras and customer service that will exceed your expectations. And right now, lease a new Acura TLX, MDX, or Integra with low lease rates available. Take luxury to a whole new level in a new Acura from Acura of Stockton and AcuraofStockton.com.
Warehouse Paint is where the local pros go for all of their paint project needs. Enjoy same-day turnarounds, same-day color matching, color consultation services, and free job site deliveries. With a large in-stock selection of PPG and Benjamin Moore paints and stains and an expert sales team that is here to help, Warehouse Paint has exactly what you need to complete your next project. Visit warehousepaint.com to find a store near you. That's warehousepaint.com.
Finding great people to hire can be like trying to find a needle in a haystack, but not with ZipRecruiter. Their powerful matching technology delivers so many qualified candidates, it's like finding a needle in a needle stack. In fact, 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. For less hay and more needles, head to ZipRecruiter.
And right now, you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right, free. At ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Hey, you want to be around people having a great time? You need to come check out Capital Casino, offering the most varieties of table games in the region in the friendliest environment. Come for the food, which is awesome, of course, and stay and play. Conveniently located in downtown Sacramento at 411 North 16th Street. Right there in downtown Sacramento for over 20 years. Cap Casino, best food, best games, and of course, the best action. And please gamble responsibly. 1-800-GAMBLER.
The Subaru service event is on at Made a Subaru Sacramento, with the largest Subaru service facility in the Sacramento area. Factory trained technicians, express service, and the all new cafe now open inside Made a Subaru. Learn more at madeasubaru.com.
Power Business Technology is proud to be 100% independent, locally owned, and managed Toshiba copier dealer. Local ownership cuts out the red tape, allowing ourselves to never be too busy to personally answer the call when our clients need us. Recognized for excellence in service execution, training, and customer service, we're proud to be named a 2022 Toshiba ProMasters Elite Dealer. Contact us today for all of your business printing needs at 844-POWER-BC. That's 844-769-3729, or visit us at powercopiers.com.
Live and local in the afternoon.
They always keep you on edge.
Cattles
and Ramie
on Sactown Sports.
Yes. I'm going to mention this quickly. And I'm going to mention it because I want to thank the listeners. We were just talking about this during the break. I won't get into details because most people couldn't care less about the details. But I do want to thank the listeners because I got on the phone today with our boss, Brian, the PD. And Rami and I got some really good news as far as the ratings go. And that's because of all of you. It's because of all of you listening, watching us on YouTube. And it especially means, I think, at least to me, a lot because – we're the quote-unquote outsiders. I've been here for about a year and a half. Rami's going on a year. And so for everybody in Sacramento that listens to this show and watches us, really, really appreciate you guys accepting us into the family and being there with us. So thank you. Again, it's you. I mean, Rami and I can come on and talk about whatever we talk about. If nobody's listening, it doesn't matter. Nobody's listening. So we appreciate each and every one of you.
Appreciate you.
Appreciate you. Speaking of the listeners, Mr. Allred noticed, and if you were watching YouTube, you likely noticed my reaction. But last segment, I did get a great question.
Yeah.
So my lead just built.
I don't know what you're doing.
My lead
that
built.
Wasn't even a, I mean, that wasn't a great question. You asked him who's coming out of the East.
Again.
Oh, wow. Oh, my brain just exploded.
No.
He asked who's coming Hold out on. Of the East. Oh, Hold my on. God.
Hold on. No. See, you asked who's coming out of the West. I asked who's coming out of the East. You know what the difference was?
What was that?
The setup.
Okay.
I said the Celtics are struggling to close games again. You got the Bucks on the brink of eliminating. Hold on. Let me finish. You want to know how to ask a great question? I'm trying to teach you right now. You're either going to take the lesson or you're not.
Probably not.
It's all about the setup. Celtics struggling to close out games. Bucks on the brink of elimination. It's also language, brink of elimination. And then Joel Embiid's injury. It's the setup.
Okay.
Now you can take that if you'd like. Just a little nugget of wisdom for you.
See, I like to just get right to the meat of the question and not waste time. I just say, who's coming out of the West? Boom.
You have not told any more of an untruth than you just told right there. By the way, AA YouTube chat says, let me see the shirt up close, Simone. My eyes are bad. There's the shirt.
I've seen a lot of these shirts.
Hopefully, I didn't just screw up the camera.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you did. Hold on.
And I also want to especially give credit to Roy Seeley, who's always in the YouTube chat. He listens to us, watches us a good amount. I give credit to Roy because Roy was one of the listeners that picked the Kings to win in five. And as a matter of fact, I said that this morning during the meeting we had, the call we had. I said, I haven't seen any of the Kings and Five people coming up in the chat. They were barking at us last week, Kings and Five, Kings and... So credit to Roy Seeley, because Roy jumped into the chat today and said, well, the Kings made me wrong. I was us in five.
Yeah, I never did a mea culpa about my Kings and Three not coming to fruition.
Yeah, that was a tough one.
That's my bad.
That was a tough one.
Sorry about that.
Gilbert Hernandez calls me the TO of radio. I love me some me.
You're very full of yourself, Nick Cattles. Very full of yourself.
Roy also tells me, that's what everybody says, Nick, you're so pompous, you're so full of yourself. Roy also says, admit you were wrong to me. I don't know.
Admit you were wrong, Nick.
I don't know what I was wrong about.
I'm sure it was something.
I said Warriors in six.
We've all been wrong about something.
Look, if the Kings win tonight, I'll be the first one tomorrow to say I was wrong. And I'll be very happy to be wrong. As I said, I will take this big fat L.
Just say you're wrong and maybe you'll hit that thumbs up.
Arthur Smith, Cattles Mento proud. Oh, God.
That wasn't a great question. You know what? I know what this
is. Listen, you are not the judge.
That was just him, like, buying a beat. You know what I mean? To come up with the answer. Great question. While he formulated an answer in his brain, and then he started talking. That's all that was. It's a cheapie.
Homer James, Rami, be careful. Some random fan came and sat behind you after the commercial break.
I think that was JJ. Pretty sure that was JJ.
So the last two times, JJ's been in the background. The first time, JJ took his own hat off of Baby Yoda.
They're like, somebody just walked off with Baby Yoda's hat. We're like, nope, that was his hat. That was his hat.
And now today, they're like, hey.
Some guy is
sitting behind you, Ronnie. Watch out.
Watch your back.
Javier says, how we feeling, guys? I'm feeling good. Rami's feeling hot and sweaty, but in this weather, but we're feeling pretty good. Simone, how you feeling? Good?
Yeah.
She's feeling so good.
Yeah, I'm damp.
JJ, you good? JJ's good.
I'm a little damp.
Moises Jr., nice to see you guys broadcasting out there, repping Sac. See y'all at the game. Yes, Moises. We are here at DOCO Live, Cattles and Rami, Sactown Sports, getting you ready for Game 5. Kings, Warriors, I was talking about it this morning, whether or not we should even ask the question if this is a must-win game. And we decided to not ask the question because we all agree this is a must-win game. Like, you can't go down 3-2 going back to Chase Center, especially with the Fox situation.
No, whoever wins this game is winning this series, Nick. I truly believe that. And I've said from the beginning, and even after the Fox injury, I didn't back off of it, that I had Kings, I think I said six. I think my actual prediction after I said Kings and three, my actual prediction was Kings and six. And I'm sitting here today and standing by that. I'd hate to come in tomorrow and do a mea culpa for the second time this series. First, my Kings and three prediction doesn't come true. If they don't win today, they're not winning this in six, obviously. And I don't think they're winning it in seven. I don't think you're going to go and beat the Warriors twice in a row, one of those being at the Chase Center. That's just too tall a task for me to wrap my head around and think that the Kings are going to do that. That's too good a basketball team. You got to get one on your home floor tonight, and then I'm feeling really, really good about their chances of getting one of the next two.
Scooter 916, if HB can get to the bucket, it's going to cause Looney and Draymond to have to pick him up, which could open up a pass and score to Domas, plus it will open up three-point shots. We talked about this earlier, man. Look, HB does not have great postseason numbers in his NBA career. He's off to a not-so-good start in this series against the Warriors. He's shooting about 25% from three, which is obviously not good. But to me, if you want to get HB going, get him to the free throw line. And I think that's crucial tonight. It's crucial for the Kings, but it's also very crucial for HB. He is much more effective offensively when he gets to the free throw line. It means that he's aggressive. He's attacking the rim. Yeah. He's forcing, as Scooter 916 says, he's forcing defenders to react to him, which, you know, opens up other opportunities for his teammates. I would love, absolutely adore, a very aggressive Harrison Barnes in the first quarter tonight. Set the tone, attack the rim, get to the free throw line, find your open teammates.
Yeah, man, they're going to need him to step up for sure. That's and Nick, there's we said this a couple times yesterday when we were talking about the De'Aaron Fox injury. Fox injured or not, I don't think they're winning this series without at least two of the three between Barnes, Herter, and Murray stepping up and having some good games here to close out this series. They need at least two of those three guys to wake up and perform consistently over the course of these next two or three games, however many more we got to go.
Yeah, I mean, and we talk about HB getting to the free throw line and attacking the bucket. But, you know, the points being made right now in the YouTube chat, everybody needs to get to the bucket. And it's true. Like, everybody needs to attack. That's I said it before this series tipped off. As we get ready for game five out here at DOCO, I'll say it again right now. The Kings have the advantage in the paint. Pound the paint. And that's not just give it to Domas. Pound the paint, dribble drive, straight line drives, attack the basket, take advantage of the switches. I've said this every time I've watched the Warriors play, and I don't know why teams don't do it. Will somebody take advantage of Steph Curry switching? Will somebody back him down into the paint? Will somebody force him to play defense? He's a good team defender. When he floats around, he can come up with steals and everything. And, you know, he holds his own water pretty well. But I've seen it so many times against this Golden State team where they have a switch and you should back down Curry, and the opposition makes it too easy. If you get that switch, back him down into the paint. Force him to play defense. Force him to foul you. Like, they need to attack the paint. That's their biggest advantage in this series. The Warriors have not been a good paint team all year long. They don't necessarily defend the paint great, and they don't score a ton in the paint.
And the Warriors, I mean, because, Nick, a lot of the things you're saying about the Warriors is true about the Kings as well. They didn't do a great job of defending the paint this year. And for the first two games, the Warriors did not exploit that. They started taking advantage of it in game three, and wouldn't you know, the series is tied 2-2 now. And them attacking the paint and taking advantage of one of the Kings' weaknesses defensively has been one of the major differences in why they've been able to even this thing up. Kings need to flip the script on them and take advantage of their weak paint defense and get some points down there around the rim.
YouTube has been fantastic today. 87 likes so far. Let's get to 100. Let's try to get to 100 by 3 o'clock. That would help us tremendously. Over 160 people watching. We appreciate every single one of you. Again, that's how this brand grows. That's how this YouTube grows. And really, this is how the community grows with all of you in that chat room going back and forth. It's like, you know, we got Monty making Mitch mentioning, hey, I'm trolling 90% of the time, guys. These two great hosts just accommodate my style of trolling, LOL. So there you have it.
Glad we could help.
Continue the conversation in the YouTube chat. We love it. Also, don't forget, you can text us at 916-339-1140. You can call us at 1-800-920-1140. Of course, we're talking Warriors. We're talking Kings. We're live from DOCO right outside of Golden 1 Center. If you're showing up to the game tonight, swing on by, say hello. We would love to meet each and every one of you. How did the Kings win if De'Aaron Fox is not himself tonight? We'll break that down coming up next.
Cattles
and Ramie.
Sactown Sports.
It's the Carmichael Dave Show with Jason Ross.
Whether it be between the third and the fourth or at some point, we got to embrace basketball hell, man. Now that we're a good team, that's a whole different meaning. And again, not trying to sell merchandise for the Kings, but, you know, there's lots of hell merchandise out there.
It would sell. Hell would sell.
Hell sells. Who's buying?
Yes. Yeah, I think everybody's in.
The Carmichael Dave Show with Jason Ross. Weekday mornings from 6 to 10 on Sactown Sports.
Right now, spring is at the Home Depot, and it's time to get growing.
Whether you're planting vegetables or herbs, or just sprucing up your indoor space with lush 6-inch Vigoro Tropicals, we have what you need to get your season started. Visit your local Home Depot Garden Center today and shop our easy-to-grow, bigger, bolder tropicals, like peace lilies, dracaena, or ficus plants. Do your spring at the Home Depot. How doers get more done. Product varies by store.
Gently used car hey,
Scott,
or truck.
You look great.
Yeah, I'm feeling good and have a new job.
No, there's something different about the way you look.
To be honest, a few months ago, I had an amazing robotic hair transplant procedure at XL Medicine. It's called the artist procedure.
No way. Your hair looks completely natural and you don't even have a scar. How did they do that?
Dude, the artist system is amazing. I have this fantastic hairline and I'm happy with my results. XL Medicine could probably help you too, buddy.
Using the ARTIST procedure, Dr. Singh and Dr. Graywall can target and harvest healthy hair follicles with micron-level accuracy from the back of your head and transplant them where you need it. The procedure is painless, and you'll be back doing your regular activities in a couple of days. Ask Dr. Singh and Dr. Graywall at XL Medicine about the ARTIST procedure. Call today, 916-932-4470. That's 932-4470 for a complimentary in-person or Zoom consultation. Or on the web at xlmedicine.com. That's E-X-C-E-L-Medicine.com. See what the artist procedure can do for you.
These are actors and not real patients.
The folks at M&S Auto know that inflation is tough on everybody. If you need an excellent, gently used car or truck, M&S has hundreds of vehicles on the lot on El Camino just off the Cap City Freeway. M&S customers get great deals and they save thousands. Get a great deal now on super clean 4x4s, including Tacomas, Silverados, and Jeeps, and muscle cars, Challengers, Teslas, Mustangs, and even the occasional McLaren. M&S Auto, msautogroup.com.
We all know the pain of being stuck in the past. But with Roseville Electric, you can get current. Roseville Electric provides you with clean, reliable electric solutions for your home or business. Whether you're looking to go electric, reduce your carbon footprint, or simply save on your monthly energy bill, Roseville Electric has a solution for you. For more info, visit getcurrentroseville.com today.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? Ah, starting trouble. No one likes that. We can get you set up for some stronger starts. You might just need a fresh charge, and we can take care of that free of charge. But if it is time for a new battery, we've got replacement batteries that'll fit your needs, starting at just $79.99. That's what makes us America's number one battery destination.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Restrictions apply.
Yes, we do have availability. Those dates for how many guests?
Andrea's Boutique Hotel is the destination to tie the knot.
Oh, you want the whole property?
She needs an assistant to catch the bookings bouquets.
249 guests, huh? Oh, and three dogs.
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. We instantly connect you with quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job description. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
When you take the time to shop at Folsom Lake Honda, there's one thing you'll always find. Happy people ready to serve you. As a family-owned and operated dealership since 2009, customer service is our number one priority. Our customers love doing business with us, and you will too.
Looking to own or lease? During the spring sales event, drive a brand new Accord or Civic. Visit us today at FolsomLakeHonda.com, your one-stop Honda shop.
Folsom Lake Honda. Yeah, your one-stop Honda shop.
Feel and hear the power of America's muscle cars and more at the Trans Am Speed Fest, May 5th through 7th at WeatherTech Raceway, Laguna Seca. Enjoy the open race paddock and be immersed among the teams. From the top of the corkscrew to the bottom of turn one, it's 3 days of racing thrills for the whole family. For tickets, call 831-242-8200. That's 831-242-8200. Or visit WeatherTechRaceway.com. The Trans Am May 5th through 7th at WeatherTech Raceway, Laguna Seca in Monterey.
From the Power Business Technology Toshiba Studios,
KHTKAM HD1 Sacramento, KYMX HD2 Sacramento,
your home for the biggest matchups in the NFL,
Sactown Sports. Sactown Sports.
Headlines.
It's Simone with your Sactown Sports headlines.
Sacramento Kings get ready for a crucial Game 5 matchup tonight with the Golden State Warriors at Golden 1 Center. Of course, the series remains tied 2-2 as both teams thus far have taken care of business on the home court. The big headline, of course, has been the precarious status of De'Aaron Fox and his fractured index finger on his left shooting hand. We will keep you updated on his status and preview this exciting matchup all afternoon, reporting live outside of G1C, leading you up to game night coverage beginning at 5:30 and tip-off slated for 7 right here on Sactown Sports or on our Sactown Sports app. I'm Simone. Those are your Sactown Sports headlines. Nate, let's toss it down to Cattles and Ramie.
Cattles and Ramie.
Cattles and Ramie. Cattles and Ramie.
Sactown Sports.
Happy hump day, everybody. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate just second hour of the radio program. He's Ramie. I'm Cattles out here at DOCO right outside of Golden 1 getting ready for Game 5 of the Warriors-Kings tonight. Of course, we all know what's happening. And the big story, Ramie, is De'Aaron Fox. He says he's likely going to play. We've had a lot of mixed reports about Fox and the non-contact practice he had yesterday.
Have we seen him arrive to the arena to know what his spirits were in, if he came unscathed, if he hit it on a steering wheel again?
I think Frankie is tailing his car. We'll get down to the bottom of it.
We have news choppers on De'Aaron Fox to make sure he gets to the arena safely.
We have Dave and his friend's private jet hovering over De'Aaron Fox at all times. With his cell phone to catch video. That's of one De'Aaron Fox.
We try to tell you, nobody covers it like Sactown Sports.
That's what we mean it.
We mean
when
it.
When we say covered, we mean covered. So again, Sam Amick said that post-practice yesterday, De'Aaron was shooting, and he seemed very, very frustrated. And at one point, he yelled an F-bomb because he missed a shot. And so that's gone around a little bit due to that Athletic article. So there's some frustration. And look, my take on the Amick thing, big deal. Honestly, like, and I don't mean like big deal seriously. I mean like not that big of a deal to me, because it's not unexpected for somebody who's dealing with an injury, right? Who just got injured and he's trying to, for the first time, work through this injury. He's a guy that's played at an incredibly high level, Ramie, all year long. Mm-hmm. He's an all-NBA guy this year. He's been absolutely ridiculously terrific in this series. He wants to win this series as bad as anybody wants to win this series. He knows how good he's been through the first four games. He knows how important he is to this basketball team. So I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised if the finger's bothering him a little bit while he's shooting, that he gets a little frustrated. I'd be frustrated. You would be frustrated. None of that matters. What matters is what happens 36 hours after that moment tonight in Game 5.
Yep. And like I said in the first hour, Nick, adrenaline and painkillers are going to play a factor in how he feels tonight. You didn't have the benefit of those two things in practice yesterday. So it concerns me a little bit. That it seems to bother her, that finger seemed to bother her more in practice yesterday than we originally thought or was originally reported in some of the things we were hearing. But that doesn't necessarily mean that's how he's going to be feeling tonight when they tip this thing off at Golden 1 Center.
Yeah,
Madonna is coming.
What?
Madonna is coming to the Golden. Sorry, I just saw the sign.
Look, there. Sun, clouds, dog, lamp, bar, chair. You okay? You good? You got to make it through?
Hey, you sent me out on the road. I'm going to be distracted.
Very excited about Madonna. Like it was 1992. You all right?
I'm a Madonna guy.
Apparently so. I haven't seen you that excited since I've met you. Madonna. Look, Nick, Madonna. Madonna's going to be here. By the way, apparently we have a lot of people. We have a lot of people in the chat. And we love every single one of you. 114 likes so far. We busted through 100. Let's
good.
Get to 150.
Hey.
Let's show the morning show that we can bump them out here with the likes and the views. Let's beat them up a little bit. But Nimi Keita obviously snuck into the chat.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, there's only one explanation for when somebody steps into the chat and asks for Nimi Keita to play.
Hold on. Just make sure you're putting the proper respect on his name. G League MVP runner-up, Nimi Keita.
P. Diddy Diddy.
Carry on.
Play Nimi as Keita. Nimi, focus on the game tonight.
You don't know that's Nimi Keita.
I have a pretty good feeling that that's...
That could be his mom or dad. You have no idea.
Hmm. Yeah.
It could be anybody from the Keita family.
The Keita family showed up. meanwhile, Ramie, how can the Kings win? Let's just say, okay, for a premise that De'Aaron Fox is below 75%, right? Like if we say Fox has given you this much, 100%, 30-plus points, and all those stats that we know, right? If Fox is below 75% of his usual production tonight, how can the Kings win this game?
It'll come down to two things, Nick. And one of these things, well, probably both of these things, they were going to need to do better than they've done in the first four games to win this game and win this series. But they did not capitalize on transition opportunities in game four of that series. I had the numbers in my notes. I had an incident with my notes this morning, Nick.
Incident with your notes?
Yeah, they didn't save. I don't know. Anyways, I'll just tell you the numbers were bad. They didn't convert in transition as often as they should have converted in transition. And those are just points that are basically given to you. You know what I mean? That the Warriors will just basically give to you. And they'll especially do it, or at least throughout this season and throughout this series, they'll especially give you the chance to get some transition points on the road.
Yeah.
Much more so than they do at home.
Yes.
Got to capitalize on those.
Yes.
No, and that's, like I said, whether De'Aaron Fox is healthy or not, you probably need to do that. But it's all that much more important when if De'Aaron Fox is 75% or less. And the other thing, Nick, is we've talked about this throughout the series. They just got to be a better three-point shooting team, man. And that goes back to us talking about Keegan Murray, who he stepped up in game four. Kevin Huerter, Harrison Barnes, you need to go back to being the three-point shooting team that you were in the regular season. And they simply have not been. They've been that for maybe a half of basketball, and that was the first half of game four.
Yeah.
Other than that, this has been a bad three-point shooting team, one of the worst in the playoffs. I think I checked, and they were 12th in three-point shooting percentage of the entire playoff field. Out of 16 teams, I think they're 12th in three-point percentage right now. You have to shoot the three-pointer better, especially if De'Aaron Fox is not himself tonight, not able to give you his regular complement of production that he's given you throughout this series as your best player.
HB and Huerter, just jumping off of your three-point point that you just made. HB and Huerter, I'd like to see both those guys shoot a combined 38% or better from three tonight.
That'd be nice.
Give me 38% or better from HB and Huerter from three. That means you're making threes. That means your offense is flowing, because if HB and Huerter are making threes, that means ball movement's happening. That means appropriate spacing. It likely means that Domas is functioning as a facilitator the way you hoped that he would. So give me 38% or above from three from both of those guys. You could throw Keegan in there if you'd like, but I'd say especially those two, because at least Keegan played really well on Sunday. Those other two guys got to get going at least one of these games.
Yeah,
please. I'm begging you. So one of those two guys has to make some shots and get going a little bit. Each of them have had one okay game. Other than that, they just haven't been good enough.
Nick, we've barely heard Keegan Murray's name chanted at Golden 1 Center to this point in this series.
It's true.
I think twice in this entire series.
It's true.
We've heard Keegan
Murray. Yes.
Thank you. We need to hear that a lot at Golden 1 Center tonight. We need to hear that a lot tonight.
But as much as we talk about HB and Huerter, we talk about Keegan, it begins with Domas. Yeah. Domas has to be better, man.
Yes.
Like, you walk into this series, you have two All-Stars.
I didn't want to cherry-pick the easiest answer to this question, but yes.
You have two All-Stars. You have two All-NBA guys, likely. One of them has been terrific. One of them has not been the same guy. Tonight is the time that Domas reverts back to Domas. And we'll talk more about Domas later in the show. But I just want to make sure we highlight that Domas has to be better for them to win if Fox is, you know, 75% or below his usual production. Something else I would say is Davion, right? Be aggressive on both ends versus Steph Curry. Don't only play the typical great defense that we see from you. Don't only get in his airspace defensively and bother him defensively. When you have Curry on you defensively, make sure you take advantage of that. Utilize your athleticism. Utilize your quickness. Utilize your speed and what you have at your disposal and take it to Steph Curry. And finally, Ramie, if you're going to win a game tonight with Fox being 75% or less, you have to win all the little things. You have to win the glass. You've got to make sure that Golden State doesn't have 15, 18, 20 offensive rebounds. You've got to make sure that Kevon Looney's not killing you with second chance opportunities. Take care of the glass, take care of the basketball, and I'll go back to the point that I made before the series began, and I made it last hour. Win the points in the paint. You need to take a big, significant advantage from the paint play. You need to outscore the Warriors in the paint. You can't have a third quarter like you had on Sunday, which ruined the game for you. I think the Warriors outscored the Kings in the paint in that third quarter on Sunday by like 12. That's inexcusable. Like, there's literally no good reason why the Warriors should outscore you in the paint any quarter of this series by 10 or more. They shouldn't outscore you, period, let alone double digits. That's not what they do as a basketball team. And what that tells me is your perimeter defense was junk, and you allowed way too many straight line dribble drives, which is exactly what they did. It was a layup line in that third quarter. Can't happen.
Nick, do you realize in game four, though, both teams made 14 threes, scored 50 points in the paint. The Kings actually had a 9-6 advantage in mid-range field goals and a 12-8 advantage in offensive rebounds, a 12-10 advantage in turnovers. The only place the Warriors played better than the Kings was that they got to the free throw line more and hit their free throws at a higher clip, and they converted more in transition. Other than that, the Kings did just about everything as well or better than the Warriors in game four.
I said it on Monday.
Yep.
I said it on Monday. The Kings were the better team in the first, second, and fourth quarters of that game. They led after the first quarter. They led at halftime. And then you went from, what was it, a 4 or 5 point lead at the half to being down 10 when you get to the fourth quarter.
Yep.
You won the fourth quarter. You won the fourth quarter comfortably.
That was one bad quarter.
I mean, you were down by 10 going into the fourth. You lost the game by one. My simple math tells me you were plus 9 in the fourth quarter.
If not for one bad quarter, that's a 3-1 series. We're not even freaking out about De'Aaron Fox. If not for one bad quarter.
That third quarter was atrocious,
man. If one shot goes down at the end of the game, we're not even that worried about De'Aaron
Fox
today.
With how tight this series has been.
Where's Dr. Strange when you need him?
With how tight this series has been, you cannot have a quarter like the Kings had on Sunday in that third quarter. You just cannot have a quarter like that. Because you have one bad quarter like that, it could cost you a game. It cost you a game. It could cost you a series. Text line 916-339-1140 is that text line for you. Don't forget the phone number 1-800-920-1140. YouTube.com, Sactown Sports 1140. We're up to 129 likes, trying to get to 150. 141 people watching right now. We appreciate it. YouTube.com, Sactown Sports 1140. We'll continue with your reaction. Kings, Warriors, Game 5 happening tonight. We're sitting right outside the G1C here at DOCO. Aside from your reaction, we'll talk about Domas. I said we're going to talk about him more. We're going to talk about him more coming up. His struggles, they're not just all on him. What can the coaching staff do? We'll tell you in 90 seconds.
Cattles
and Ramie.
Sactown Sports. Are you ready to hear this on Sactown Sports?
Hand off McCaffrey. Touchdown! San Francisco!
Or how about this?
Feel super, baby! Five-time Super Bowl champions, and they're looking for number 6.
Catch every Niners game during the 2023 season
on your home for the 49ers.
Sactown Sports.
I'm Howard Mackler, founder of Innovation Refunds. You've heard me talking about the payroll tax refund for months. If you own a business, even if you've asked your CPA about this, you owe it to yourself to take another look. We provide a licensed and insured tax attorney who evaluates your company at my expense to determine eligibility. Businesses of all types can qualify, so go to GetRefunds.com to potentially get a payroll tax refund of up to $26,000 per employee. Download the Innovation Refunds app or go to GetRefunds.com, GetRefunds.com.
In business, everything your employees do impacts your brand.
including what they wear. Cintas has high-performance workplace apparel for almost every job imaginable. From work shirts and pants, to polos and khakis, to oxfords or t-shirts, these clothes move, breathe, and look great. Your team gets the styles they like, you convey the image you want. And Cintas service includes weekly laundry and delivery. To learn more, visit Cintas.com.
Oh, I'm ready!
And get ready for the workday.
One brings Maklof magic, while the other, we're still trying to figure that out.
Paddles and Rami.
Sactown Sports.
We'll get right back to the Kings Warriors, but an interesting story popping up just moments ago in the NBA, Rami. According to DenverSports.com, Anthony Edwards, who was terrific in that series against the Nuggets, Edwards has been cited for third-degree assault for allegedly striking two women with a folding chair. Per Colorado law, third-degree assault carries the punishment of up to 18 months in jail and or a fine up to $1,000. My guess is Ant will not get the 18 months in jail. But I'm starting to kind of dig for more details on this story. I don't know if he threw the chair into the crowd or if he, I mean, I don't know how he hit two women with
Nick,
a folding chair.
We saw the video here. He picked it up and kind of swung it around just out of pure anger, it looked like, and it didn't even really look like he hit them, allegedly. I don't know what I can say, but it didn't look that bad.
Wait, was this on the floor after the game?
It was after the game in the tunnel. Yeah, he kind of picks up a chair and swings it around. Just like, not you know, you get upset. It was not like an attack at these women at all. Nothing like that.
Right, like he wasn't going Stone Cold Steve Austin
not
in 1999.
I got you.
I think grabbing the folding chair and smashing people.
Yeah, frustration, picked it up, kind of ran away. In the video, it's really hard to tell exactly what happened, but it didn't look too bad.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll keep an eye on it, but that's the latest on Anthony Edwards. And like I said, he was terrific in the series, but obviously not a great situation that he finds himself in. And he's not going to get 18 months. He's not going to get any time in jail.
I want to root for that dude, man. He had that stupid incident.
I thought you were going to say I want to root for jail time.
He had that stupid incident last offseason. And we talked about it yesterday, Nick. I even appreciated the way that he handled that. He's like, yeah, I screwed up. I got to be better. I'm going to try and be better, which is all I ever want from people when they screw up. And then you got this. Like, I really, really want to root for the guy. He seems likable. His game is insane. He's, what, 22 years old?
21, I think.
21 years old, and he can just take a game over it seemingly anytime he wants. Want to root for the guy, man, but you got to be smarter than that.
He was ridiculous in that series.
So good, dude.
But, yeah, look, as long as there's not malicious intent,
sure.
You hope that he figures it out. You know, you hope that he understands, you know, what he did and how he messed up and learns from it. As long as, like I said, he wasn't going around intentionally trying to hurt people, then that makes you feel at least a little bit better. Not great, but a little bit better about it. Text line, before we get to Domas, because this ties in. Text line, 916-339-1140. Why is Looney able to put up Rodman-like rebound numbers, specifically on offense? All right, so offensively, It could be the defensive coverages from the Kings. You know, it's your rotations. It's the fact that if you get Domas on a switch off the pick and roll action, now you're taking Domas away from the glass, which leaves Looney with a matchup with a guard or a wing. And that is going to be obviously an advantage for Kevon Looney. So that's one thing. Another thing is just not keeping a body on the guy. You know, I mean, if it's not a switch, if it's not a rotation issue, it's the fact that you're just not keeping him boxed out. And it might sound just so simplistic, but it's true. Like, look, sometimes, man, even at the NBA level, guys forget to put a body on a guy. And they let him, you know, take advantage of that. But Looney is not an unbelievable athlete. I mean, he's an NBA player, so he's an athlete. But
he's an unbelievable athlete compared to us out
right,
here.
He's got about a 15-inch vertical, if that. I mean, he's not an explosive athlete with incredible verticality. So Looney gets rebounds by out-hustling you, getting position and taking advantage of those rotations and beating other guys to the glass and using his size to out muscle other dudes when he has the size advantage. That's how he's doing it. And that falls somewhat on Domas, obviously, right? Domas has to make sure that he's accounting for his guy. If he gets stuck in a rotation and he's trying to defend, Curry off a pick and roll, then it's going to be difficult to do that. But if that's not the case, then make sure you got your guy locked up. And Domas in this series, Rami, he's averaging 16, 12, and 4.5 assists. That is roughly 2.5, almost 3 assists less per game that he averaged in the regular season. That's one issue. Another issue is he's shooting 48% from the floor, which is dramatically down from his over 60% in the regular season. We talked about it on Monday, the restricted area. He's missing all these bunnies.
Yeah.
He's had a ton of bunnies that he's just flat out missed. His shooting percentage in the restricted area is like, I think, around 30% less than it was in the regular season. It's crazy. And he's also averaging 4 turnovers a game, which is not good. When Domas has high turnover games, we've seen it. When he has high turnover games, that usually means the Kings offense is not as good as it has been the rest of the year.
And we were talking with Sean Powell of NBA.com in the first hour, and I asked him, is this something the Warriors are doing to Domas, or is this self-inflicted? And he seemed to think it was mostly self-inflicted, and that's been the way I felt while watching it, Nick. He seems to be in his own head, especially when the Warriors give him a little bit of space to work with there at the top of the key or the free throw line, and he just kind of stands there with the ball over his head trying to decide what to do with it when he should either just take a shot or find an open man and keep the offense moving the way that he did all offseason long. He's got to do something with it, and he's got to stop overthinking this thing. I don't know if it's the playoffs. I don't know if it's just that the Warriors are giving him so much space to work that he has too much to think. I don't know what it is, but this has not been the guy that we saw all regular season, just watching him when he gets the ball in his hands there inside the three-point line.
And look, with Fox hurting, tonight's the night.
Yes.
Like, you can't have that drop-off with Domas moving forward. He has to give you at least regular season Domas, but it's not all on him. That there are some things that the coaching staff can do. I'll give you one thing especially. I'd like to see this team run pick and roll with Domas involved in that action. I'd like to see 1-5 pick and roll. I'd like to see 2-5 pick and roll. I'd like to see Fox and Domas in a pick and roll and get Domas rolling to the bucket and force Looney to try to trail him, right? Or get the mismatch and force a switch. I'd like to see more pick and roll with Domas involved and have him rolling to the bucket. And that's how you get him in the restricted area with a couple of dunks, a couple of layups, and then he starts feeling good about himself. I think they should run a lot more pick and roll with Domas. I also think they did some of this. They did some of this early, and I think it was game 3. They ran some, screens, inverse screens, and it's a simple thought process. Instead of Domas setting the screens, have some of your guards and wings set screens for Domas. Run those inverse screens to get them loosened up a little bit. These are a couple of things that they could do more of. And I would also say, look, don't give them a ton of free throw line touches if he's going to dribble or try to dribble his way through it. And that falls on Domas, where he's going to make quicker decisions. But two quick things I would do tonight, coaching-wise, to try to free him up a little bit. Again, I'd run more pick and roll with Domas in the action, and I would also run some screens, have guards and wings screening for Domas to try to get him free.
But if he's not decisive, assertive, aggressive, Nick, that won't even – I agree with you. Those things will put him in position to put up some better numbers than what we've seen. But if he's not decisive, assertive, and aggressive, that won't even matter. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He needs to assert his will on Looney and the rest of that Warriors defense and impose his will on this basketball game. And he's good enough to do it. I maybe he just doesn't know that he's good enough to do it. Sometimes that's what it takes.
And stop hesitating for 15 feet.
Yes.
They are literally...
That's driving me crazy, man. I can't tell you how many times he's gotten the ball out there, and I'm screaming at my TV, do something.
They are literally gifting him 15-footers.
Yes.
And he keeps turning them down.
Yep.
If he hits a couple of those, that's going to cause Looney to have to step up. He can't sag underneath the free throw line. If you're knocking down the 15 to 18 footer, Looney can't play off of you through the whole game. He has to step up, and as soon as Looney steps up, that's when you start taking advantage of the DHOs and the pick and rolls and the screen game and all of that stuff. That action comes off of the jump shot. Domas isn't, you know, incredible in the mid-range like De'Aaron Fox is, but he's more than capable of making that shot. He has to take that shot with confidence, and that will force Golden State to react, because right now, Kevon Looney's saying, man, you're not going to take the shot. I'm not going to respect you to take that shot.
Daring you. He's daring you.
Why should I move up on you if you're not taking that 15-footer? Prove it to me.
Yep.
And Domas has been unwilling to do it. He has to step into those shots tonight. He has to take those mid-range jumpers and earn that respect. 916-339-1140. The text line, the phone number is 1-800-920-1140. YouTube.com. Sactown Sports 1140. Give us that thumbs up. We're trucking towards 150 likes. That is the goal within the next 10, 15 minutes. Do it for Simone. Do it for JJ in the background. Do it for Baby Yoda,
man. Come on.
Indeed. The Celtics choke. Devin Booker's on a heater, and we'll have more coming up next.
Cattles and Ronnie.
Sactown Sports. Check out the Golf to Go Hour with Brett LaRosa every week on Sactown Sports. Get the latest on equipment, area courses, people who play the great game, and plenty of good conversations about golf. It's the Golf to Go Hour every week with Frank LaRosa on Sactown Sports. Golf to Go is brought to you by the Hagen Oaks Golf Super Shop, America's most awarded golf facility. Naturewood Home Furnishings, where it's all about choices and always about quality.
Do you find yourself stuck in a timeshare? Get the real facts about the timeshare industry and your options for cancellation. Chuck McDowell, founder of Wesley Financial Group, has put together a free information guide that reveals the secrets the timeshare industry doesn't want you to know, including the five ways to get rid of your timeshare. Call now and get this timeshare information guide absolutely free. Call 800-785-1155. That's 800-785-1155. 800-785-1155.
Since the 1950s, Warehouse Paint has been helping local homeowners and professionals bring color to life. Whether it's painting your home's exterior, repainting kitchen cabinets, or finding the perfect accent color, Warehouse Paint's expert team is here to help. You'll find a great selection of PPG and Benjamin Moore paints, along with local service you can trust. With five Sacramento area stores, Warehouse Paint is ready to help bring your next paint project to life. Visit warehousepaint.com for a store near you.
Truck season savings extended at Meta Chevy in the Elk Grove Auto Mall. Got a huge selection of new 2022 and 23 half-ton Silverados in stock, ready to go. Find your savings at MetaChevy.com. Find new roads.
Kevin Lewis of National Garage Door. Whether you need to repair a broken spring, install a new opener, or buy a quality Rainer door, National Garage Door is here for you. Call us today to see how we can transform your house with a new garage door.
638-4554 National Garage Door.
Hey, Sacramento. While you're watching the playoffs, don't get stuck on the bench in a warm house. Fox Family Heating and Air can get you cooling fast with most parts backed by a lifetime warranty.
Fox Family Heating and Air.
When you're ready to get properly fitted for golf clubs, join the thousands of Northern California golfers who visited the indoor-outdoor Hagen Oaks Player Performance Studio. Players of all abilities found the Hagen Oaks Player Performance Studio offers answers to questions about golf club fitting. You'll find a professional staff of fitters, major equipment brands, and cutting-edge technology featuring TrackMan. See for yourself at the Hagen Oaks Player Performance Studio, Fulton Avenue at the Cap City Freeway. Call 916-808-2531 to schedule your fitting. 808-2531 for longer, straighter drives.
Guys, did you know your testosterone level impacts your energy, libido, sleep, weight, hair loss, mood, and even ED? And right now, Revive Men's Health Sacramento will check your testosterone for free. They've helped thousands of men since 2011 feel and perform better. They're so confident they can help you, they even guarantee it. Schedule your free testosterone test, exam, and consultation today. Call 916-277-8599. That's 916-277-8599. Or visit revivemenshealth.com.
Jiffy Lube's Country in the Park, Northern California's biggest country music festival of the year, is back May 5th and 6th at Cal Expo, starring Lady A,
Chris Young,
I should be halfway home at all now.
Brett Eldridge,
I wanna be that song,
and so many more.
Plus, a Boots Boot and Line Dance Saloon, interactive lounges, and Sacramento's best food trucks. Weekend passes start at just $80. Tickets are on sale now at SactownSports.com. Country in the Park, brought to you by Cash Creek Casino Resort, Hanley's Western Wear, and Quick Pack Car Wash.
Great team, great team. Where's the defense? Defense! Okay, everyone take a break. Greetings, Sacramento. Doug Christie here for the Good Feet Store, asking, when is something too good to be true? When it probably is, and had I not experienced it for myself, this spectacular season would definitely qualify as too good to be true. So everyone out there in radio land, continue to enjoy. Something else that could seem too good to be true is Good Feet Arch Supports. But trust me, I've experienced firsthand the comfort, balance, and support possible with Good Feet Arch Supports. And so have countless others who have pretty much given up hope. It's time you felt good again. Take your feet to the Good Feet store for a free personalized arch support fitting and test walk. Experience for yourself the comfort, balance, and support missing in your life. The Good Feet store in Sacramento, Roseville, Stockton, Modesto, and now Vacaville, online at goodfeet.com.
The wait is over. Meta Subaru has a great selection of new Subarus in stock, more arriving daily, and big savings on all of them. And you can see all the savings at metasubaru.com. So what are you waiting for?
Sactown Sports.
Headlines.
It's Simone with your Sactown Sports headlines. Sacramento Kings get ready for a crucial Game 5 matchup tonight with the Golden State Warriors at Golden 1 Center. Of course, the series remains tied 2-2 as both teams thus far have taken care of business on the home court. The big headline, of course, has been the precarious status of De'Aaron Fox and his fractured index finger on his left shooting hand. We will keep you updated on his status and preview this exciting matchup all afternoon, reporting live outside of G1C, leading you up to game night coverage beginning at 5:30 and tip-off slated for 7 right here on Sactown Sports or on our Sactown Sports app. I'm Simone. Those are your Sactown Sports headlines. Nate, let's toss it down to Cattles and Ramie.
Your afternoon home for Kings Talk and more.
This is Cattles and Ramie
on Sactown Sports.
Cattles and Ramie on a Wednesday here at DOCO outside of the G1C live with all of you getting ready for game 5 tonight. Warriors and Kings, of course. We'll continue with your thoughts on the series, your thoughts on De'Aaron Fox. Text line. I just want to mention this. So Simone, we'll peek behind the curtain. Simone is in charge of pulling the texts and letting us know which texts have come in. Yeah. She is the editor. She's
the filter. She's a gatekeeper.
She's the gatekeeper of the text.
Yeah.
Do we think it's a coincidence that Simone put into the chat the text that read, "We listen for Simone." Not a coincidence, Ramie.
Not at all.
That the gatekeeper.
Not even a little bit.
The gatekeeper is pushing through compliments from the text line.
That's not shocking at all. Not even a little bit surprising.
That ego. That ego of our lady
We're
here.
We're creating a monster, man.
Yep.
I'm telling you.
Frank and Antelope has a prediction for Fox. You ready?
Yes.
18 points, 14 assists, 5 rebounds.
I'll take that.
18, 14, and 5.
I'll take that.
I would, too.
With a broken finger?
The finger situation, yes.
I'll take that.
And if he gives you that, it goes directly back to what we talked about earlier in the show. You need HB and Herder to shoot well from three. You need to win the glass. You need to win in the paint. You need to make your threes at a better clip than you have. Take care of the basketball. Domas has to up his production. Those things, if they fall in line, a stat line like that from Foxy, I think, gets the job done.
Yes.
But you need all those other guys to step up, which they're capable of doing.
Did we find out, by the way, if De'Aaron Fox arrived safely to the arena without banging his finger on a steering wheel again?
I think Simone is checking again.
Catching it out in his pocket while he was going to get his keys or something.
As we said earlier, the morning show host is hovering above De'Aaron Fox today in his friend's private jet, making sure that things are going well for De'Aaron Fox. We're waiting for the update from the morning host. He should let Simone know. And if not, our failsafe is Frankie, who's just stalking De'Aaron Fox.
Hiding in his trunk.
Yes.
Of his car.
Yes. We'll get right back to Kings Warriors, but I did want to mention what happened last night. Ramie, I told you yesterday.
Hey, dude.
During a break. I didn't say it on the air.
I couldn't remember if this was an on-air or off-air conversation.
Off-air. And I told you, I told Rami yesterday, said I will not be surprised if this Boston-Atlanta series goes back to Atlanta for a game six. And Rami said, you're crazy. This series over. It's done. It's over. I said, listen, the Celtics are going to Celtic. And what that means is they're going to make it as tough as humanly possible to win every series.
They play with their food, don't they?
Yes. They love playing with their food. They did it last year. Now, they swept the Nets in a very, very tight series. That was misleading. They won one game in the final moments with a Tatum layup. But then they should have taken care of the Heat in six games. They didn't. They should have taken care of the Bucks in six games. They didn't. They were up 2-1 against the Warriors. This is what this team has done in the playoffs. And it really just it goes back to one simple thing to me. And I've watched a ton of Celtics games. I've watched pretty much every single Kings game. If I know two teams in the NBA, it's these two teams. It goes back to the same thing that we saw last year in the postseason. It's the fact that they run their offense through Marcus Smart and Jason Tatum. And both of those guys have the same bad habits in the final 4 to 5 minutes of a game offensively. They both lack consistent urgency on the offensive end in the final 5 minutes. They both settle for threes way, way, way too often. They make it easy for the opposition, and they're both careless with the basketball. And so when you're running your offense through those two guys and they have those habits and they continue to have no urgency, they continue to settle for bad shots, especially against a team that you can easily drive and score at the bucket. I mean, the Celtics, whenever they drive, they get a layup in the series. But for some reason, Tatum's taking 11 threes, 12 threes, 13 threes, 10 threes. He's just jacking them up, and he's shooting 3 of 11. He's shooting 4 of 13, and he's settling for these threes. And Smart does the same thing. So, you know, until Tatum realizes...
You're not worried about the series, though, right?
Until they should win this series. Okay. But, again, if they play up to their potential, they get to the finals. But this team has that special quality of making everything tougher on themselves. And they obviously did not learn from last year's run that you can't play with your food. They're about to play, you know, if they do take care of business against Atlanta, you're playing Philadelphia, and losing that game last night, you just gave Philadelphia extra rest for Joel Embiid. You got to take care of your business. And so that's Tatum's biggest issue. Tatum's biggest issue is at the end of games, he plays around a little bit. He gets caught dribbling on the perimeter forever for no reason. He takes bad threes. He settles for threes. And as long as he and Smart play that way, this team's going to have a very hard time to winning a championship. Phoenix also eliminated the Clippers, 136-130. Devin Booker went for 47, 8, and 10. And Rami, Booker's statistics, man, this guy is on an absolute freaking heater. When you go back to his last four games in the series, he averaged 40 points and shot 62% from the floor. Mm. He's the only NBA player in history to do both of those things across a four-game span in the playoffs. History. In NBA history. Averaging 40 points and shooting 62% from the floor.
Is there a grain of salt with that? Doing it against a Clippers team without Kawhi for three of the four games and no Paul George?
Not when you do that. I mean, we're talking in history. We're talking against bad defenses. That's historic what he did. Still concerned about that Phoenix defense, though. I mean, you just mentioned it. No Kawhi, no PG, and the Clippers scored 70 points in the first half last night. They scored 130 points in that game. And you're going against a team that's missing its two superstars?
Yeah.
So Phoenix's defense is not good right now.
You know who I
gotta figure that out.
Really good for in this series. He's probably not happy today because they lost. But Russell Westbrook, man. Because I'll admit, last year when things were at their ugliest with the Lakers and he was Westbrook and everything else and couldn't seem to do anything right, it got to the point where I was like, man, I love Russell Westbrook, and I don't want to see this continue down this road. I think the best thing for him is to retire, Nick. And even though they lost, with Leonard going down, with Paul George going down, and him really being the guy that kind of kept him in these last couple of games, I think he redeemed himself and shut a lot of people up with the way that he performed and earned a lot of, I don't want to say respect because they already respected him, but the praise of some of those guys on that Suns team for what Russell Westbrook was able to do in that series. I was really happy to see that. He's a guy that I root for, and I'm really glad that he was able to make this a happy story again in terms of Russell Westbrook and the player that he is.
That's pride. That's compete level. That's, you know, showing that you care. And I thought Russell Westbrook did all of that
yep.
when he moved to the Clippers. He could have, you know, he could have cried in his own tears and you know, not done much of anything, and it would have been what it was, right? Oh, well, it is what it is, and Russell Westbrook just doesn't have it anymore. But he has pride, and he made it a point when he got to the Clippers to prove to people that he still has game. And, you know, he was resilient in that series, and I give a lot of credit to him. Denver also eliminated Minnesota. Minnesota made it tight. I mean, yeah, that was a fun game back and forth late, but Jokic closed it out. And Anthony Edwards, we said it earlier, he is clearly the number one guy. And he is, by the way, clearly a number one guy on an NBA team.
Gobert and Towns, to quote Jay Triano, there were times of last night I didn't know which team they were playing for, to be quite honest with you. That was those two guys, man. They, I mean, all the talents in the world between the two of them, but just some boneheaded stuff, dude. Just some boneheaded stuff from those two guys sometimes.
All right, Rami brings his quick Twitch skills to the draft mockery coming up.
Cattles
and Rami.
Sactown Sports. The Kings dropped a heartbreaker to the Warriors in Game 4.
Harrison Barnes with a launch for three. It's no good. It came off the heel as time expires.
With a series tied at 2, the Kings look to regain the series lead Wednesday at the Golden 1 Center. Our coverage starts with Cattles and Ramie live from DOCO at 2 p.m., followed by tip-off at 7 on Sactown Sports.
Sactown Sports first-round coverage is brought to you by
National Garage Door. Quality doors, quality people.
Sacramento weather is brought to you by Bonnie.
I'm Mark Finan in the KCRA 3 Weather Center. Skies will stay clear through the night tonight. Our overnight lows will drop down to the mid-50s. Tomorrow will be sunny and warm with a high of 92. Get the latest forecast on the KCRA 3 News and the KCRA 3 app.
A nice warm shower is not so nice if it doesn't drain like it should. Well, let's fix that right now. Get a sewer inspection, including mainline drain cabling and video analysis, just $97. Plumbing, sewer, electrical, heating, and air, Bonnie.com. Bonnie.
Sorry, but we actually have a wait list for our Monstera.
Shaw's greenhouse is really bringing in the green.
We can't keep snake plants and stuff.
She needs a construction manager to build on her roots and grow.
We could add a whole section for ferns. Here we'd have dahlias, dahlias, and more dahlias.
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly!
Did you know 1 in 4 car batteries is weak and needs to be replaced? O'Reilly Auto Parts will test your battery for free. If your battery needs to be replaced, our professional parts people can help you find the best superstart battery for your vehicle and budget. Don't wait. Get your battery tested for free today at your local O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly! Auto Parts!
Get to Acura of Stockton, where precision-crafted performance is at your fingertips. Elevate your driving experience with a vehicle that's built to impress. Acura of Stockton has a great selection of new Acuras and customer service that will exceed your expectations. And right now, lease a new Acura TLX, MDX, or Integra with low lease rates available. Take luxury to a whole new level in a new Acura from Acura of Stockton and AcuraofStockton.com.
The summer is heating up with some of your favorite country stars at Lake Tahoe Outdoor Arena at Harvey's.
Featuring country's biggest stars.
Dierks Bentley's Gravel and Gold Tour, Friday, August 4th. Sam Hunt's Summer on the Outskirts Tour, Sunday, August 13th. Darius Rucker's Starting Fires Tour, Saturday, August 19th. King Brown's Drunker Dreaming Tour, Thursday, August 31st. And Friday, September 1st.
Don't miss these country all-stars plus more.
Tickets are on sale now at Ticketmaster.com and ApeConcerts.com.
Carmichael Dave here, welcoming back my dear friends at Fire Wings. 21 different flavors. I had 4 of those 21 Saturday for the game, watching with the family. As always, breaded Malaysian curry. Yeah, you better bet I got that curry. Knocked it out of the park, too. Go to firewings.com to make your order. That's what we did. We ordered 2 hours in advance, picked it up. There's nothing better for the game than Fire Wings. Check out the locations nearest you. Fire Wings! Just wing it.
What would it take for a plumbing company to earn your trust? Jerry and Kenny here from Bell Brothers. And let's face it, plumbing and service companies don't always have the best reputation.
So to earn your trust, the first thing they'd have to do is actually answer the phone when you call with a real live person. Then they'd have to send a plumber when you needed them, day or night, without charging extra for emergency services.
A trustworthy plumber would show up on time, wearing a clean uniform and name badge, and be able to show that they had passed a background check and drug test.
A plumber you could trust would give you a firm quote on the job before starting and clean up after they finish the job.
That's exactly the plumber you'll get when you call Bell Brothers. A plumber you can trust. Call Bell Brothers right now for all your plumbing needs. Our number is 916-444-1234 or find us online at thenosurpriseguys.com.
The No Surprise Guys, Bell Brothers.
We're in the room and we're checking boards.
Do you think we're being serious?
Nah.
It's the Mockery Draft.
All right, so let's get to the mockery draft, draft, as we get ready for the NFL draft tomorrow night.
Let's go.
It's so weird realizing that the draft's tomorrow night. We haven't spent any time on it, obviously, because, you know, we're talking Kings. I've done so much draft talk in my life, like the last 10-plus years on radio.
Yeah.
It's so odd to not do anything on the draft leading up to it, but that's what happens when the Kings win 48 games with the three seed and are playing the Warriors. These things are great. It's a good thing we haven't talked about.
That's what that is.
Yeah, it was a first world problem. Is that what we got? That's what they call them. All right, so because of the NFL draft being tomorrow night, we figured we would run through some of our favorite draft terms that are used during draft coverage. Okay, so some of the things that writers and pundits and analysts use time and time and time again when explaining, describing certain players and their traits. Let me pull up the order here for a second. A little bit slow service. We got JJ, Simone, myself, and then Rami. So let's start it with JJ. JJ gets the first draft term.
I get to go first. I didn't know that.
This is one of those where I don't know if you want first because there's just so many good ones. You know what I mean?
That's all right. That means I got plenty of QBs to pick from. So I'm going to start with my first one is I'm going with one of the ones that gets on my nerves is this guy plays through the whistle. Plays through the whistle. No, he doesn't. No one plays through the whistle 100%. That's a lie. I don't care what anybody says. Plays through the whistle.
Excellent.
The whistle is the whistle. Yeah. The whistle means stop.
Yes.
Simone.
Let me go ahead. I have a whole list. I think I'm going to have to go with a classic here. He's got great football IQ, ladies and gentlemen.
See, I use IQ a lot. I can't kill it. Right? I use football
got a great IQ.
I use
got
basketball
great IQ.
IQ.
Oh, one of my favorites. It's a hit.
All right. I'm next. He's a hard hat guy.
Yeah.
Yep.
Let's
get your,
puts his hard hat on and he goes to work, Tommy.
Let's build that. Yeah, I had hard hat and lunch pail.
Yep.
That's the first on my draft board.
That was
number one on my draft board, Nick. You got it right before me.
All right, how about this one?
Okay.
How about this one? Fluid hips. Yes, fluid hips.
Wait, why are you doing two?
Yeah, absolutely not.
Why are you doing two?
Trying to steal one.
Roll up a flag and push you 10 yards back.
You settle down.
I can't believe it. This guy. Sit down and let Bobby go.
We are on very similar wavelengths here, Nick, because after hard hat and lunch pail,
you got to take mine now.
It's along those lines. I like it better. The oily hips.
Oily hips.
Lubricated hips. So I'm gonna go with oily hips and
some lubrication on them hips
and high motor guy
was on the top of my list.
Yeah, man, love a high motor guy.
I can't go hips now when you went hips.
I don't think so. No, that was you showing your cards, man. You jumped the gun.
You know what happened during the break? Simone's playing a drum solo on her microphone on her headset. And it rattled my brain. She keeps moving the mic.
The good people of Sacramento are asking for things and I'm providing. I'm sorry.
Unbelievable.
I'm not sorry. What are you going to do, Nick? What are you going to do?
What you got?
He's a football player.
Classic.
Of course he is. This guy's a football player. Oh, I'm glad that you're drafting a football player in the NFL draft.
That's good.
Glad you identified the football player.
You want to draft football players.
Yeah.
Getting a baseball player, not helpful.
Yeah.
That is not useful.
True. Makes no sense.
Yep.
Gentlemen,
back to you, Simone. Right?
I think it is me.
Yep.
It all really starts with the quarterback. really mortgaging that future. I just would really like to get that out there. It all really starts with the quarterback.
It all starts with that guy.
And that is my piece.
That is a good one.
I'm going back to back here. I'm going, he plays well in space. I mean, you're playing in space. Versus playing well in no space.
And then, right,
he's a phone booth guy, one of them, too.
Phone booth guy's a good one.
I think we have a lot of people who love statistics, you know, analysis, all those different things.
Yes.
His tape is better than he tests. That's the one that he gives me. Okay. So you're basically saying he plays well in games.
Right.
Cool. No problem.
I love that.
Where are we at now? Simone.
Back to Simone. You guys, he's deceptively quick.
Deceptively quick.
That's kind of a piggyback pop of Jay here. But he's deceptively quick. It's one of my favorites out there.
That's another good one.
Plug in and play.
Here's another one. This guy has all the tools.
Yes.
Which means he really hasn't done enough.
Yeah.
But he's got the tools. He's toolsy, Ramie. He's got
all the intangibles.
He's got all the tools. He's got all the intangibles. This guy might have had one sack in his senior year, but he's got tools. If he puts those tools together, he could be special.
He's got a lot of upside.
My last one, there's a number of different ways to put this. Character issues,
red flags.
Yes.
off the field issues, any one of those. You're going to see that with a few guys. So I'm going to go with that for my 100% third and final pick.
Demon says that, LOL, Nick, I hate when people say that. That has to be my number one. I'm guessing he's a football player.
There are so many good comments in the YouTube chat right now. This guy is perfect, from Katie Vieira. Russell, a prototype. Russell again.
Prototype is good. Prototype is a good one. Mm. Yep.
Swiss Army knife. Oh, absolutely.
Untapped potential.
Amadrock.
How many times do we hear comp tomorrow night? This guy's 100%. Comp is.
Amadrock, he's a mechanic.
He passes the eye test. Yep.
CCG with he passes the eye
Absolutely.
Test.
Absolutely. What else do I still have on the cutting room floor? Oh, very coachable.
He
can get upfield.
Locker room guy. Locker room leader.
Yep. Straight line speed. Gotta get straight line speed.
All he does is make plays, you guys.
He has good gap integrity.
Yes.
That's a good one.
Tremendous upside. I don't know what he takes. Tremendous upside.
I had that on here.
Generational talent. Great ball skills.
He high points the football.
High point. Lots of guys are going to be high point.
I forgot about high point.
This might have been my favorite draft mockery ever. Excellent stuff.
He's here. He's your typical north-south runner.
Yes.
He's handsy.
Handsy's a good one.
He's handsy. There's so many.
They're weird ones. Hear about intangibles tomorrow.
Yeah, intangibles.
For sure.
He uses his legs well, from Craig.
You know what he does well? He uses those legs.
Great reach or short arms. Arm too short is another one that you'll hear.
Oh, my goodness. Just a unicorn out there on the field. Unicorn. An anomaly.
Vincent Ramirez, by the way, says we should be broadcasting from the pool above the Sawyer.
I'm with it.
If we can make that happen, I'm down.
End of show. You and I would both jump into the pool.
Yeah. Totally.
That'd be the grand finale.
Have you guys been up the Revival?
Have not.
Oh, no, solid. Especially at that.
I gave that a recommendation to you, Ramie, for date night one time.
Oh, you did? You got to go up there. Both of you guys, for sure. We have to go up there.
I'll make it happen.
Yeah,
let's do this.
Who's coming to my party on Saturday?
I'll be there.
JJ.
I'll be there.
Yeah.
I will.
We'll see.
One last note here from the text line regarding our draft mockery. We have, how about this guy's got nonstop motor?
High motor guy.
High motor. 209.
High motor. How about, I like the fun ones. Cow on ice. He's like a cow on ice.
Is a good one. Yeah.
Alligator arms is a classic.
Yeah.
He's got sand in his pants.
I've never heard that.
Yeah,
for
big fat defensive tackles.
Oh, okay. Hard move.
He's got sand in his pants.
Never heard of that one.
Anyway, it is something else.
We could all be.
We should make bingo cards.
Yes.
For the draft.
We come up with 100 of them.
I want to remind you about the Folsom Lake Honda Hotline. Every time we have guests, they join us on that Folsom Lake Honda Hotline. Coming up, would we start Davion Mitchell tonight?
Cattles and Ronnie.
Sactown Sports. Catch the Oakland A's every weekend on Sactown Sports. Friday nights, Saturdays, and Sundays.
Thinking that's going to get down for a hit. Around third, your score is Tony Kemp. And the A's have taken the lead. Edge of the track, makes the catch. And the Athletics get a great win.
Sactown Sports, your weekend home for the Oakland A's.
Sactown Sports coverage of the Oakland A's is brought to you by Xfinity 10G, the next generation network.
Right now, spring is at the Home Depot, and it's time to get growing. Whether you're planting vegetables or herbs, or just sprucing up your indoor space with lush 6-inch Vigoro Tropicals, we have what you need to get your season started. Visit your local Home Depot Garden Center today and shop our easy-to-grow, bigger, bolder tropicals, like peace lilies, dracaena, or ficus plants. Do your spring at the Home Depot. How doers get more done. Product varies by store.
Ross here, and ACR did a great job for my family, bringing their impeccable reputation and great workmanship to keep my family covered with a brand new roof. Now we're comfortable and dry during Sacramento's rainy season, knowing our home's structural integrity is protected, our value has increased, and the home itself, well, it's looking and functioning at its best. The proof, it's in our roof. Now you could get this same quality experience with ACR Solar and Home Services. Just go to acrsolar.com now to sign up for a free estimate and see all that they have to offer, not only to protect your home and family during the cold and wet Sacramento weather, but also including premium made in the USA solar electric systems. That's acrsolar.com. ACR Solar and Home Services is bringing us all the highest quality, highest value, and integrity since 1979. Go to acrsolar.com. That's acrsolar.com.
Attorney Joe Cordell. Business owners and professionals face special challenges in divorce court. In addition to everything else going on, they have to contend with allegations that they are earning more than they are, coupled with claims on their business or practice itself. Clients with assets depend on their divorce lawyer's skills in these matters, and that's why it's so important to hire someone that has those skills.
500 Capitol Mall, Suite 2060, Sacramento, California, 95814. CordellCordell.com.
Gah, I'm so stressed. Our business is growing. We've got people all over now.
Ooma.
What is that? Meditation?
I'm recommending the Ooma cloud phone system with auto attendant and more than 50 features.
Ooma?
Yep. Switching to Ooma is a cinch. Just $24.95 per month per user, plus taxes and fees.
Ooma.
Now you're feeling it. Find Small Business Calm at Ooma.com/radio. That's OOMA.com/radio.
Make your way to the ballpark on Sunday, April 30th to watch your A's go head-to-head with the Cincinnati Reds. Get there early to grab your very own Tony Kemp poster presented by Kaiser Permanente. This one-of-a-kind poster giveaway features TK and his iconic catch.
Diving play to his right. Unbelievable catch by Tony Kemp. Spectacular.
Tickets start at just $10 and are available at athletics.com/tickets. That's athletics.com/tickets.
Hey, basketball fans, the playoffs are here and Sacramento's ready to win it all. And while you're cheering them on, you're going to want a nice, cool home to watch those games in. That's why you should call Fox Family Heating and Air for all of your air conditioning repair needs. With our amazing technicians and lifetime warranty on most repairs, we'll make sure that your home stays cool and comfortable for the playoffs. So come on, beat the buzzer and call Fox Family Heating and Air today.
Fox Family Heating and Air.
Depression, anxiety, and trauma can happen to anyone. You aren't alone. 1 in 5 of us will have a mental health issue in our lifetime. And just like other illnesses, people who get support and treatment find healing and hope. Check in with someone you're worried about. And if you're feeling pain, ask for help. There's no shame in taking care of yourself or the people you care about. Be there for someone who's hurting, even if that someone is you. Learn more at StopStigmaSacramento.org.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly.
Improve visibility and save $8 instantly when you pick up a pair of Bosch Icon wiper blades at O'Reilly Auto Parts. Bosch Icon Premium Blades can help you see better and drive safer. And our professional parts people will install them for you for free. Stop by your local O'Reilly Auto Parts today or visit O'ReillyAuto.com.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
KHTK AM HD1 Sacramento, KYMX HD2 Sacramento.
From the Power Business Technology Toshiba Studios, your local sports leader in the 916.
This
is Sactown Sports. Sactown Sports.
Headlines.
It's Simone with your Sactown Sports headlines. Sacramento Kings get ready for a crucial Game 5 matchup tonight with the Golden State Warriors at Golden 1 Center. Of course, the series remains tied 2-2 as both teams thus far have taken care of business on the home court. The big headline, of course, has been the precarious status of De'Aaron Fox and his fractured index finger on his left shooting hand. We will keep you updated on his status and preview this exciting matchup all afternoon, reporting live outside of G1C, leading you up to game night coverage beginning at 5:30 and tip-off slated for 7 right here on Sactown Sports or on our Sactown Sports app. I'm Simone. Those are your Sactown Sports headlines. Nate, let's toss it down to Cattles and Ramie.
With you 1 mile at a time during the afternoon drive, Cattles and Ramie.
Sactown Sports.
Frankie C in the house just walked by. You gonna join us on the air today?
Where's Frankie?
Oh, no, not right now. I don't know.
4:15? 4:30?
No, we got 4:15 already.
Oh yeah, that's right.
About 5 o'clock.
It's too late.
All right, we're booking an interview with Frankie live on the air. This is incredible radio. Text us, let us know. Rock star. Frankie
peek behind the curtain, man.
Peek behind the curtain. So Jason Anderson is set to join us in about 10 minutes. So, we'll talk to, Jason Anderson from the Sacramento Bee. Always great to catch up with him. And, we got a lot more to get to about this game. Cattles and Ramie on this Wednesday. Happy hump day to everybody. Live coming to you from DOCO right outside of the G1C, getting ready for Warriors Kings. Should be an electric atmosphere tonight. We both agree this is a must-win game. I think a lot of people feel like this is a must-win game. You cannot afford to lose this game and then go back to chase for the for game six, especially with the Fox injury and all the unpredictability about how he's going to look and all those things. So tonight is a must-win. And don't forget, YouTube.com, bunch of people on there right now, over 130 people watching and going back and forth in the chat,
YouTube.com,
Sactown Sports 1140. And don't forget, when you swing by, give us that like. Give us that thumbs up. It would be very much appreciated. Trying to get to 150 likes. We're at 133 right now. So Sactown Sports, 6A to 6P, Monday
That's
through
easy.
Friday.
Come on, people.
Live and local. All right, Ramie, let's talk Davion Mitchell. I tweeted this on Sunday watching Game 4 at Nick C Radio. At Nick C Radio, at Ramie is tweeting. I tweeted on Sunday, I would start Davion Mitchell game 5. And that was before the De'Aaron Fox injury. That was before anything we've talked about the last few days. I tweeted on Sunday that I would absolutely start Davion Mitchell in this game tonight. And I would replace Kevin Huerter with Davion Mitchell. Would you be okay with that?
I don't think so.
How dare you?
For a couple of reasons, Nick. One, we talked earlier about what you're going to need to do tonight if you have a 75% or less De'Aaron Fox. And I said, if it's 100% De'Aaron Fox, you're going to have to shoot the three ball better. You got to shoot the three ball better than what you have to this point in the series if you have any chance of winning it. And to me, that means you got to ride or die with Kevin Huerter, because Davion Mitchell ain't going to come in and light the world on fire with his three-point shooting. That's just not something that's going to happen in this series. Nick, you need Kevin Huerter to wake up to win this series. I don't think you win it if that doesn't happen, unless De'Aaron Fox has an out-of-body experience, or Keegan Murray or Harrison Barnes. If one of those guys absolutely goes off, maybe you can make up for the no-show
by Kevin Huerter when it comes to the three-point game. But the other thing is, and look, man, I want Mike Brown to play the substitution game as much as possible. And whenever Steve Kerr gets up off the bench to check into a game, you try and get Davion Mitchell checked into the game to try and stick that guy. But let's be real about what Davion Mitchell has done to Stephen Curry in this series. He's made life hard for him.
Yes.
But he hasn't stopped him.
No.
By any means.
No.
You know what I mean? So really, how much more are you getting in terms of, let's put it in terms of plus minus, Nick, by having Davion Mitchell in there to defend Steph Curry? What are we talking about? 4 more points over the course of a game that he might get that he wouldn't have gotten if Davion Mitchell was on him? Because the guy's putting up 30 points a game in the playoff series. That's not to minimize or demean what Davion Mitchell is doing. He's making a name for himself with the way that he's sticking on Steph Curry like white on rice throughout this series. But as far as the actual impact, because Steph Curry is who he is, it hasn't been great. You know what I mean? The impact hasn't been great enough that I take that trade off over the possibility that Kevin Huerter wakes up and starts hitting some threes.
All right, number one, I would say, I'm not saying don't play Kevin Huerter.
Right.
I mean, the way you're framing that, it's like you're just putting him on the bench and he's not going to touch the floor. I'm not being that dramatic about it. You can certainly play him a bunch of minutes tonight. I mean, Davion's playing 28 minutes when Huerter starts. So, you know, if you're going to play Kevin Huerter 25 minutes, you could still play him 20 to 25 minutes just coming off the bench.
Fair.
Instead of being the guy who's going to start. As far as the defensive numbers, look, that's the low-hanging fruit, as you put it earlier in the show. But I do have some numbers to tell you how Mitchell has played against Curry in this series. He has this is from Professor Oak on Twitter, so shout out to Professor Oak, who's fantastic. Mitchell has guarded Curry for 113.7 partial possessions in this series. When Davion defends Steph Curry, Curry has shot 10 of 20 from the floor, and he has scored 23 points, and he has shot 3 of 9 from three-point land. So he's making it tougher. There's no doubt about that. If you're wondering about offensive rating, and this is really where you look, because we can all get wrapped up in the individual matchup, but it's how that matchup impacts the rest of the offense for the Warriors. How much, so to speak, is Davion Mitchell junking up the Golden State offense? And when Mitchell defends Curry, the Warriors' offensive rating in this series is under 99. Their offensive rating is 98.5 when Davion defends Curry. Don't get lost in just Davion versus Curry. Look at the totality of what you see. And what we've seen is an offense that was really good in the regular season, and easily over like 110, right, in offensive rating this season. When Davion is defending Curry, the rest of the offense has problems to the point where they're underneath 99 offensive rating. That, to me, is a gigantic difference. That is a significant difference between the Warriors that you have when Davion is not out there defending Curry and the Warriors that are out there when Davion is defending Curry. But on top of that, Ramie, it goes deeper than just the defense and why I would have Davion in this game. Let's not forget what's going on with De'Aaron Fox, right? I mean, with De'Aaron Fox's injury, we don't know how he's going to handle the basketball. We don't know his level of defense. Can he play on-ball defense on Curry like he has earlier in the series when he's swipe of the Fox? Is he going to be that aggressive? So you might need a guy out there to handle the basketball. Kevin Huerter's not that guy. Davion's that guy. You might need somebody out there to make sure that the defensive intensity continues with the unknowns about Fox, you know, in his hand. Davion's that guy. Davion's athletic. He explodes to the rim. Huerter can score, and Herter's got some decent athleticism, but I like the idea of having some of your best athletes on the floor against this Warriors defense because, as we talked about earlier, it allows you to attack them in the paint. So it's not just defense versus Curry. I think with Fox's injury, I think it's even more important that Davion starts tonight because of those other things.
And also, you won't have to have De'Aaron chasing Steph Curry around the court defensively when you have Davion Mitchell out there. I get that, Nick. As long as, look, man, it doesn't matter how you put together the minutes puzzle. Bottom line is, this team needs to start hitting some threes. And I'm at the end of the day, going back to your first point when you talked about just because Davion is starting, because doesn't mean that Kevin Huerter is not going to get minutes. You got to figure out who you can get out there on the floor and get some offense generated and get some three-point shooting going. If you can do that, whatever that combination might be with Davion Mitchell out there for a good chunk of this game, then so be it. And whether that means that Harrison Barnes is on the bench or Kevin Huerter or whoever else might be giving up those minutes for a Davion Mitchell, bottom line is somebody's going to have to start hitting some three-pointers, Nick. And Davion Mitchell ain't going to do that for you. He, like you said, he might muck it up on the defensive side and make things harder for the Warriors, but you got to outscore this team. You're going to have to put up some points to win this series, and that's going to come down to hitting some three-point shots. You need Kevin Huerter to wake up.
Speaking of Davion defending Curry, here he was this week talking about just that.
It's been okay. I think I got to do a better job of staying connected. He's getting a lot of open looks. A lot of clean looks where it gives him a lot of rhythm. End of the day, I'm just trying to stay connected and do my job.
So just trying to do my job. And here he was telling us what the key is when you defend a Steph Curry.
Just not relaxing. I think that a lot of people, when you guard anybody, you relax after they pass the ball. But he does a really good job, and his team does a really good job of looking for him after he passes the ball. So after he passes the ball, he's still – that's when the game really starts. So you just got to be – you just got to have in mind, like, I can't relax throughout playing guarding this dude because he's gonna get off, he's going to get separation, he's going to knock the shot down. So, I mean, just having that mindset of just staying connected to him.
One more thing about Davion, if he starts, now you don't have to rely on his scoring, right? You don't have to have him come off the bench and give you an offensive punch. If you have Davion out there along with some of your other best offensive players like Fox and Keegan and HB and Domas, then you're not relying as much on his offense, and you could use Herter's offense coming off the bench. With all of that said, I mentioned this earlier in the week. I'm not telling you it's the end of the world. Like, if they don't start Davion tonight, I'm not going to lose sleep. I'm fine with them rolling the same starting five out there that won them 48 games and have them, you know, tied 2-2. I don't think this is like, oh my goodness, what a huge screw up by Coach Brown.
Mm-hmm.
But I would lean towards starting Davion. But it's not, again, I also see the point of let's keep it, you know, to our level of comfort. Let's keep the continuity. Let's do what we've done. It's gotten us here. Let's not overreact and go too crazy.
And you got to have shooters on the floor.
Yeah,
got to have shooters on the floor, man.
Jason Anderson from the Sacramento Bee will join us in 90 seconds to talk Game 5.
Cattles
and Rami.
Sactown Sports. Sactown Sports wants to congratulate Kings head coach Mike Brown for being the first coach to unanimously win the NBA Coach of the Year Award.
100 first place votes, first time ever.
Wow.
A unanimous decision.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, everybody. I'm really appreciative of being in Sacramento. The fans, the city has been fantastic.
How will Coach Brown lead the Kings during the playoffs?
Tune into Sactown Sports and SactownSports.com to find out.
Guys, did you know your testosterone affects everything in your system, including how you feel and perform every day? Right now, Revive Men's Health Sacramento will check your testosterone for free. Knowing your T levels is the first step in understanding if you have low T. Your testosterone level impacts your energy, libido, sleep, weight, hair loss, mood, and even ED. Maintaining an appropriate T level can change your whole life. Most men start to see changes in their hormone levels in their 30s. Experience and results matter. So what are you waiting for? Get your T levels checked today by local, experienced, and trusted men's health experts. They've helped thousands of men since 2011. They're so confident they can help you, they even guarantee it. Call Revive today and schedule your free testosterone test, free exam, and free consultation. Call Revive Men's Health at 916-277-8599. That's 916-277-8599. Or visit RevivemensHealth.com.
The following is a test of the emergency alert system. This is only a test.
Live. live and local in the afternoon.
They always keep you on edge.
Cattles
and Ramie
on Sactown Sports.
Here we are, just three guys with sunglasses. Cattles, Ramie, Jason Anderson from the Sacramento Bee.
Three cool cats.
Just three cool cats here out at DOCO. Outside of the G1C, Jason Anderson, he's joined us an awful lot on this program throughout my first roughly year and a half or so. And, of course, as always, he's on the Folsom Lake Honda hotline. Folsom Lake Honda, your one-stop Honda shop. Jason, we appreciate you coming by, man. Great to finally sit down with you in person. Obviously, the big story tonight's De'Aaron Fox. What are you hearing? What do you expect?
Well, the story definitely changed yesterday when we walked into the gym. We didn't expect to see De'Aaron at all. Didn't expect to talk to him. Certainly didn't expect him to come out and say, no, I'm playing. But that's what happened. And so here we go. They've upgraded him to questionable, but he left no doubt about it yesterday, saying, no ifs, ands, or buts. I'm playing tomorrow night. And so I think we're going to see him. We'll see how effective he is. He spent a lot of time on the floor after practice yesterday, just kind of getting the feel for the way the ball's coming off his fingertips with the splint on. And so mixed results, I would say, from what we observed after practice. We'll see if maybe he's kind of figured that out tonight and if he can be De'Aaron Fox.
I've heard suspicion of shenanigans, gamesmanship going both ways, that initially the way that it was reported was exaggerated. So the Warriors didn't know what to get ready for. Maybe De'Aaron and the Kings put a good face on it yesterday and made it look better than it really is. Do you get the sense that there's any of that going on, or have we gotten the full story on the De'Aaron Fox finger injury?
I think that's nonsense. I mean, if the Kings were really trying to, hide something with De'Aaron specifically, you leave it a mystery up until game time, you run him out there in the starting lineup. So the fact that they put him out there yesterday and we watched him on the floor and we talked to him and got to hear, him kind of tell us what was going on. I think that's baloney, frankly.
Jason Anderson with us from the Sacramento Bee. Jason, we just talked about Davion Mitchell, the idea. I would like to start him tonight. Any chance of that happening, or do you think Coach Brown just rolls out what we've seen?
I don't know. It's an interesting thought. Mike, hasn't told us that, and I don't think he would even pregame. But it's an interesting conversation to have. Some of their best lineups have been with Davion on the floor. What he brings defensively as just a tenacious on-ball defender is something that very few guys in the league can do. So you add that to the fact that Kevin Huerter has struggled to get the shot falling. He's shooting 14% in the playoffs. I think he's 3 of 21. I think there's a conversation to be had there. But you need – I think if you're going to win this series, you need to get Kevin going.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
You're going to need him. Especially if Fox is going to be limited to any degree in terms of what he gives you offensively. You got to get Kev going. You got to get HB going. You need Keegan to continue to do what he did in game four. And that's going to be your best chance to win. But, they've made some adjustments on both sides already. I felt like the Warriors were kind of trying to hide Steph from Davion a little bit in a couple of those early games.
Yep.
If you watched, Davion comes on the floor, Steph goes and takes a seat. Davion leaves, Steph comes back. And so we've seen this chess match between Mike and Steve up to this point, and I don't think that's over. We very well may see another adjustment or two as we go through these last three games.
What do you think is going on with Domantas Sabonis? I know that's a big, broad question, but what do you think is going on? Like, do you think it's what the Warriors are doing to him? Is he doing it to himself? Why hasn't he been the guy that we saw in the regular season?
Yeah, the Warriors have schemed them really well on specifically the dribble handoff stuff that the Kings like to do in their offense. So much of it is built on DHOs, and they've just blown that up. So they're sagging off of him when he's got it, the ball at 15, 18 feet, daring him to take that shot. And then they're really disrupting what they do in the DHO game, which has contributed to some of the poor shooting numbers that I just alluded to. They're getting open shots, but they're not the same shots they were getting during the regular season, where Huerter curls behind a screen from Domas, takes the DHO and shoots 40%. So they're making adjustments to some of what the Warriors are doing. Warriors have done it really well. They've done a good job, and yeah, they've made things difficult for Domas thus far.
Jason Anderson is with us from the Sacramento Bees on the Folsom Lake Honda Hotline. Folsom Lake Honda is your one-stop Honda shop. We're outside here of DOCO getting ready for game one. Just a fantastic atmosphere. I'm sure over the next hour, this place is going to get packed. A little bit warm, but Rami's trying to stay focused through the warmth. Jason,
I officially sweated through my shirt.
He has saw the stains. He tends to have some issues from time to time.
I don't handle the heat well, Jason.
So Harrison Barnes, we talked about him earlier in the show. And to me, Jason, he hasn't been nearly as aggressive as he should be. What do you think can get him going? Because, you know, when you look at his postseason numbers, he hasn't been necessarily good in the playoffs through his career. How do you get him going if you're the Kings tonight?
Well, I think, you know, for all of them, and Kevin said this specifically, you want to see a shot fall. Like if you can get the first one to go, you can knock down a couple early. That's big for confidence and rhythm. And I think that should be, you know, maybe a point of emphasis for them tonight. You know, Mike has talked about them driving into traffic and you know, going at 2-3 guys where they collapse in the paint.
Right.
And they're just looking for calls. And so now you don't get the call, you don't get the bucket, and you're getting beat down the floor because you're standing there asking the referee why he didn't call a foul. So Mike says, look, we can't – the way he put it was interesting. I wrote about this. He said, you're asking for like Mike's a big UFC guy. You're asking for a judge's decision.
I didn't know that. I'm a big UFC guy.
Yeah. So
there you go.
He says, if you do that, you're asking for a judge's decision. We're not going to win a decision against the defending champions. We've got to knock them out.
Yeah.
And so he wants, you know, get into the paint, but make the right read. If the defense collapse, just kick it out, find an open 3-point shooter. And as Mike likes to say, let that thing fly.
Which Warriors team do you expect tonight? They were Jekyll and Hyde on the road and at home this season. So far, to a degree, that's played out in this series. You ask Steve Kerr, some of those guys, they'll tell you that they're a different team now, and that's not something that they're worried about. Which team do you expect to show up?
Yeah, I mean, coming into the playoffs, I figured that would be the case, that, you know, look, the regular season is the regular season. The playoffs are the playoffs, and they know that well, and they're healthy now. Their roster is – everybody's available. I did not expect to see the same kind of road struggles continue in the playoffs, but here we are going into game five and they're 0-2 on the road in the playoffs. So I don't know. They, you know, nothing has changed yet. So I think everybody has that sense with the Warriors that they can flip a switch and turn it on and just hit you with one of those big waves where they just crush you. But it hasn't happened here on the road so far. For them, it did certainly in game three when they were at home, but we'll see if they can find that tonight. It you know, they may not. They're a little older than they've been, obviously, over, you know, the last 9 years. The series, the way it sets up now, you have one day between games and not two, which they had a couple of times over the first four games. And so you would think that's maybe advantage Sacramento with the younger legs. De'Aaron's injury throws a little bit of a wrench into that sort of thinking, just because how much time might he need between games to feel right. So some of that remains to be seen. But, you know, that's one little advantage that I kind of looked ahead to for the Kings, where over the last three games of the series, assuming we have three more, that may play into their hands a little bit.
His name is Jason Anderson. He's from the Sacramento Bee. Jason, it was great to meet you.
You
hang out in person a little bit, my guy. Always great on
appreciate
Twitter.
You. Yeah, I got to go. I've got tickets for Ramie and Lance Woods at
The
Punchline tonight, 8 o'clock. DVR that game. If you're not going to be here, just DVR.
Set it up perfect for him. We'll talk. We'll continue to talk Kings Warriors coming up next.
Thanks, guys. Cattles and Ramie.
Sactown Sports. It's the Carmichael Dave Show with Jason Ross.
Whether it be between the third and the fourth or at some point, we got to embrace basketball hell, man. Now that we're a good team, that's a whole different meaning. And again, not trying to sell merchandise for the Kings, but, you know, there's lots of hell merchandise out there.
It would Kings sell. Hell would sell.
Hell sells. Who's buying?
Yes. I think everybody's in.
The Carmichael Dave Show with Jason Ross. Weekday mornings from 6 to 10 on Sactown Sports.
Finding great people to hire can be like trying to find a needle in a haystack.
but not with ZipRecruiter. Their powerful matching technology delivers so many qualified candidates, it's like finding a needle in a needle stack. In fact, 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. For less hay and more needles, head to ZipRecruiter.
And right now, you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right, free. At ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
There's really nothing better than hitting the open road in a new Honda. And at Northern California's number one Honda dealer, Sactown Honda, we are proud to provide our best selection to get you there. Buying from Sactown Honda couldn't be smoother. Wherever the road you travel might lead, Sactown Honda is happy to get you there.
Anytime, anywhere, it's all here. Sactown Honda.com.
Great team, great team. Where's the defense? Defense! Okay, everyone take a break. Greetings, Sacramento. Doug Christie here for the Good Feet Store, asking when is something too good to be true? When it probably is, and had I not experienced it for myself, this spectacular season would definitely qualify as too good to be true. So everyone out there in radio land, continue to enjoy. Something else that could seem too good to be true is Good Feet Arch Supports. But trust me, I've experienced firsthand the comfort, balance, and support possible with Good Feet Arch Supports. And so have countless others who have pretty much given up hope. It's time you felt good again. Take your feet to the Good Feet store for a free personalized arch support fitting and test walk. Experience for yourself the comfort, balance, and support missing in your life. The Good Feet store in Sacramento, Roseville, Stockton, Modesto, and now Vacaville, online at goodfeet.com.
I'm Ken Korak with your Green and Gold Report, brought to you by Xfinity 10G, the next generation network. Well, the A's have a great story in pitcher Mason Miller. Diagnosed with juvenile diabetes in 2018, he got bigger and stronger, and by the time he made his big league debut on the last homestand against the Cubs, after only 28 and two-thirds innings in the minor leagues, he threw 15 pitches at 100 miles an hour or faster, topping out at 102.5.
Now batting, Xfinity Internet. It's made to do anything, so you can do anything. Supercharge your home with incredibly fast and powerful supersonic Wi-Fi. With 3 times more bandwidth, it covers all the bases and then some. And strike out billions of threats with advanced security that helps keep you safe at home and on the go. If you're keeping score, that's internet that does it all. That's unbeatable internet from Xfinity, proud partner of the Oakland Athletics. Restrictions apply. Not available in all areas.
When you take the time to shop at Folsom Lake Honda, there's one thing you'll always find. Happy people ready to serve you. As a family-owned and operated dealership since 2009, customer service is our number one priority. Our customers love doing business with us, and you will too.
Looking to own or lease? During the spring sales event, drive a brand new Accord or Civic. Visit us today at FolsomLakeHonda.com, your one-stop Honda shop.
Folsom Lake Honda, yeah!
ACR Solar and Home Improvements did a great job to keep my family covered with our brand new roof. And what an experience that was for us. Now we're comfortable and dry during the Sacramento rainy season, and our home value has increased. Plus, the home itself, it's looking and functioning at its very best. And you can get the same quality experience with ACR Solar and Home Improvements. ACR Solar and Home Improvements has been bringing us all the highest quality, value, and integrity since 1979. Go to acrsolar.com.
Sactown Sports
Headlines.
It's Simone with your Sactown Sports Headlines. Sacramento Kings get ready for a crucial Game 5 matchup tonight with the Golden State Warriors at Golden 1 Center. Of course, the series remains tied 2-2 as both teams thus far have taken care of business on the home court. The big headline, of course, has been the precarious status of De'Aaron Fox and his fractured index finger on his left shooting hand. We will keep you updated on his status and preview this exciting matchup all afternoon, reporting live outside of G1C, leading you up to game night coverage beginning at 5:30 and tip-off slated for 7 right here on Sactown Sports or on our Sactown Sports app. I'm Simone. Those are your Sactown Sports headlines. Nate, let's toss it down to Cattles and Ramie.
Live and local in the afternoon.
They always keep you on edge.
Cattles
and Ramie
on Sactown Sports.
We got to let people know what happened when Jason Anderson was leaving.
Unreal, man.
So we had Jason Anderson on the show last segment from the Sacramento Bee. Fantastic to catch up with Jason in person.
Yeah, for sure.
Jason was like the first guy when I moved to Sacramento to reach out to me personally.
Oh, nice.
And welcome me here. And he said nothing but great things about the station and some of the things that we've done. So I really appreciate Jason.
Good man.
I appreciate him a little less now, though, because when he was leaving, he walks by. And I swear to anybody who's listening to this program, Jason Anderson says, goodbye, Ramie. Goodbye, Nick. You know, all that good stuff.
Daps up, Jay.
Says, Simone, it was a pleasure to meet you. And then says the thing that will live forever now within the fabric of this show. Simone, you have the best voice on the entire station.
Hands down. He followed it up with a hands down.
Hands down. And Simone, with such glee in her face, she could not hide it. And I said, this ego is just, it's getting worse and worse. She's not going to be able to fit that big head into her SUV later on tonight.
We're going to have to get her a drop top. We're going to have to get her a convertible just so she can drive around.
No.
That big old head.
It'd cause accidents. We don't want that. It'd be like Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. We don't want any of that. by the way.
Simone's head float, ladies
she's like,
and gentlemen.
Just floating around. Say, ooh. 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 Losing control over big head and all that. Anyway.
We should make a GIF out of that, by the way, if anybody at digital is listening.
Anywho, by the way, thank you to all the people on YouTube. YouTube.com, Sactown Sports 1140. Some fantastic stuff today so far from all of you. By the way, I also want to mention 169 views. Nice. Which we're getting closer to 200. I don't think we've ever had 200 likes on this show on YouTube. So let's try to get to 200. YouTube.com, Sactown Sports 1140.
That should be
we
easy.
We would absolutely love it.
Let's go.
YouTube.com, Sactown Sports 1140. We're up to 170. Let's get that to 200. And, oh, my God, everybody's just – all these people about Simone. Some of it gets a little out of bounds. We gotta keep it clean here, people. RH says, is Nick actually getting some sun or is it just my imagination? It's your imagination. No, sun.
We're in the shade.
I'm still Casper.
I've already got some color.
Almost translucent. Very, very concerned about Saturday. I'm going to be honest.
I am a desert people.
People
so.
Coming over. I'll be outside. I'm very concerned about what damage that might do. But
my skin handles the sun well. The rest of me, nah, not so much.
Not great.
Not great.
No, you don't like it.
No.
We're still waiting for a report from the morning show guy who is supposed to be chasing down De'Aaron Fox.
On his friend's private jet.
Yes. Alfred E. Newman said, morning host guy, trusted with Fox security. We're in deep-ass trouble.
No, not security. No, he's on reporting duty. We wouldn't put him on security.
Manny Too Legit says, Ramie, how are you going to watch the game if you're having a show tonight?
I will watch the game with Lance Woods at Punchline backstage, and whatever I miss, I will watch on a replay when I get home.
Lance must be an absolute trip to watch a game.
2023,
he's going to be out of his mind.
I'm actually looking forward to that because he's one of the most insane Kings fans that you'll find.
Lance is going to be
I don't know if they have the capabilities to air it for the attending audience at the Punchline, and we all could watch it with Lance Woods. Quite honestly, that might be the best show we could put on.
Arthur Smith says, Sacramento will just have to treat the game like De'Aaron Fox has five fouls and play to the adjustments. Yeah, you know, as we get closer and closer, it's going to be fascinating to see what the plan is going in. You know, I think you go in if Fox is going to play, and we haven't been told otherwise. Fox is playing tonight. You go in thinking 35 minutes, hopefully, right? And if he gives you 35 minutes, that means things are going well. He's getting through it with health. He's looking good. He's producing. That would be the greatest. That would be the perfect plan. That's what we all want to see. It will be interesting, though, if Fox gets a little bit of pain early on in this game. He's kind of reacting to it. He doesn't look comfortable. Yeah, I'd imagine that Coach Brown, Ramie, and the rest of the staff, they've gone through, you know, here's plan A through Z.
Yeah.
In case Foxy's not really feeling it.
Got to have multiple plans when you go out there tonight because you just don't know how it's going to react, Nick. And he said, you know, it's the playoffs. Everybody's hurting in some way at this point. But I told you, I've had broken bones in my hand before, and the lightest touch can be stop you in your tracks type of pain. You know what I mean? Where whatever you're doing, you just stop for at least a beat and take a breath and gather yourself. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And he did that knocking it on the steering wheel, getting into his car. That's not Draymond Green and Kayvon Looney swatting down and chopping down at his hand as he goes up for a layup or a dunk in the lane.
Edward Rendon, I'm here. Light the bleeping beam.
Let's go. You wouldn't be able to see it. Too bright, but yeah.
Edward actually swore in the YouTube, and the comment got hidden, but I liked the comment, so I actually pulled it, and I cleaned it up a little bit.
There you go.
So shout out to Edward.
Editorial decision by the Cattles.
Every once in a while, I'll make those. I think it was the right decision. Let's go to Doug. Doug's on the phone. He wants to talk about Warriors and Kings tonight. What's up, Doug?
Sir, how are you?
Good.
Good. Hey, I heard your the Jason Anderson thing. You got to look at the he didn't say good or great.
That's right.
That was
not a single good or great
question asked by it.
Frankly, a bad interview by him.
Yeah.
So the Kings have exceeded my expectations. Back in October, I had them fighting for the playing at number 10. So they far exceeded that, got the third. I only had him winning one game in the first round against the Warriors. I'm playing on house money. My question is, though, I believe that Harrison Barnes does not get enough touches to be able to make a opinion on how effective he is. If had an effective rate to do the number of times that he got touches and then what he did with those touches. Because he's not the first option. He's not the second option. He's not the third option. So he's getting very few touches, and when you find out, and I think I mentioned this before, when he gets between 15 and 20 points, the Kings win maybe 60 to 70% of the time. Just your comments. I love your show. Thank you.
I don't know the numbers, Nick, but I haven't sensed that HB is getting any fewer touches than he did in the regular season. Do you? Does
not
anybody
really
keep track of touches? I'm sure
not
somebody's
really
keeping
track
of touches.
I will say, you know, De'Aaron's been very aggressive, which is fantastic.
Yeah, you want that.
He's been pretty busy when it comes to taking shots and being active. You know, everybody's going to get a couple of touches less when, you know, De'Aaron takes 31 shots in game four. 31 shots. In game three, De'Aaron took 22. In game two, he took 23. In game one, he took 27.
Oof.
So, and again, that's not a bad thing. I like when De'Aaron is aggressive, and they've needed aggressive De'Aaron Fox to be 2-2 in this series, right? So I have no bones to pick there. It's just, you know, when De'Aaron's taking 27, 31 shots in a game, it's only natural that, you know, some of the other guys are going to get less looks. But, you know, that's why it's going to be. We talk about adjustments from the coaching staff, but just adjustments from his teammates. How do you adjust to Fox tonight? Again, if he's not feeling great, if the finger's bugging him and, you know, he doesn't go out there and take 20-plus shots. Now those other looks are going to go to the other guys, and they got to make the most of them.
You think I could expense a DPOG chain from the team store with the company?
I don't know.
Could I expense that? I mean,
it's a shirt, maybe.
It's a prop for the show. I would wear it out here for the show.
Rami, I'm no longer the program director, so I feel uncomfortable
that
answering this
true.
Question. This is a question for Brian.
Brian, if you're listening.
Oh, he's listening.
Can you?
Brian's always listening.
Can I expense a DPOG chain, sir?
He's texting you right now. No way in hell. Not happening. By the way, incredible output from those at the YouTube channel. 204 likes. We've cracked 200 likes
for the first time
as a show. We love you. We appreciate you. 204 likes. Bobby's going to get a little greedy. Let's try to get it to 225 start?
250. Let's go.
I told you he's going to get greedy.
I was getting greedy.
We love each and every one of you. Again, YouTube.com, Sactown Sports 1140. Let's keep on popping it. 916-339-1140 is the text line. 1-800-920-1140 is the phone line. Phone line's open for you. I also want to tell you, and you could hear the crowd, we're picking up a little bit of traffic.
Yes, sir.
People are starting to walk in. It's a little bit slower today than prior games here at DOCO.
Yeah, people don't want to stand in the heat.
Yeah, because it's like 90 degrees, 90-plus degrees. So
I appreciate that.
So if you're wondering, if you're planning on showing up a little bit later, so is everybody else.
Yeah.
not a good plan for you. You might want to leave now because you're going to get stuck in the rush.
Yeah, that's that Uber or that Lyft and head on out.
Yeah, just a safe suggestion, some advice for you. Waiting tonight might not be the best plan of attack.
Bobby's riling up the crowd again with the rally towels.
Bobby's wearing a long sleeve shirt. I don't
know how he's doing it.
Man,
this guy out here is in the 3-piece suit.
Yeah, he looks good though.
He looks good. You know what I mean? But I would have sweated through all three layers of that thing by now already.
All right. My anger at some NBA GMs only builds. We're going to get to that. We'll also continue with your Warriors Kings thoughts coming up. Cattles and Ramie live from DOCO outside of Golden 1 Center.
Cattles and Ramie.
Sactown Sports. Sactown Sports is Sacramento's new home for the San Francisco 49ers.
It feels awesome. We deserve this. Let's go, Niners!
Purdy.
Purdy gonna throw, and it is Kittle in the back of the end zone.
Samuel.
Debo 10. Debo. Touchdown!
And McCaffrey.
Touchdown! C-M-C!
They all live here on Sactown Sports.
Your official home for 49ers football.
Power Business Technology is proud to be 100% independent, locally owned, and managed Toshiba copier dealer. Local ownership cuts out the red tape, allowing ourselves to never be too busy to personally answer the call when our clients need us. Recognized for excellence in service execution, training, and customer service, we're proud to be named a 2022 Toshiba ProMasters Elite Dealer. Contact us today for all of your business printing needs at 844-POWER-BZ. That's 844-769-3729, or visit us at powercopiers.com.
Jiffy Lube's Country in the Park, Northern California's biggest country music festival of the year, is back May 5th and 6th at Cal Expo, starring Lady A,
Chris Young,
I should be halfway home, but all
Eldridge,
I wanna be that song,
and so many more. Plus, a Boots Bootin' Line Dance Saloon, interactive lounges, and Sacramento's best food trucks. Weekend passes start at just $80. Tickets are on sale now at SactownSports.com. Country in the Park, brought to you by Cash Creek Casino Resort, Hanley's Western Wear, and Quick Hot Car Wash.
Yeah, I'm so stressed. Our business is growing. We've got people all over now.
Uma.
What is that? Meditation?
I'm recommending the Uma cloud phone system with auto attendant and more than 50 features.
Uma?
Yep. Switching to Uma is a cinch. Just $24.95 per month per user, plus taxes and fees.
Uma.
Now you're feeling it. Find small business calm at uma.com/radio. That's OOMA.com/radio.
I'm Howard Mackler, founder of Innovation Refunds. You've heard me talking about the payroll tax refund for months. If you own a business, even if you've asked your CPA about this, you owe it to yourself to take another look. We provide a licensed and insured tax attorney who evaluates your company at my expense to determine eligibility. Businesses of all types can qualify, so go to GetRefunds.com to potentially get a payroll tax refund of up to $26,000 per employee. Download the Innovation Refunds app or go to GetRefunds.com, GetRefunds.com.
Make your way to the ballpark on Sunday, April 30th to watch your A's go head-to-head with the Cincinnati Reds. Get there early to grab your very own Tony Kemp poster presented by Kaiser Permanente. This one-of-a-kind poster giveaway features TK and his iconic catch.
Diving play to his right. Unbelievable catch by Tony Kemp. Spectacular.
Tickets start at just $10 and are available at athletics.com/tickets. That's athletics.com/tickets.
California, the birthplace of all things cool. Beautiful people, perfect beaches, and cruising with the top down on Route 66. It does get quite hot here, though. So now that spring has sprung, Ace Plumbing Heating and Air is offering a full air conditioning system inspection and tune-up for just $66. Call 455-4548 and just say Route 66 to get your kicks and stay cool. Ace Plumbing Heating and Air, 455-4548 or at aceplumbing.com.
Get to Acura of Stockton, where precision-crafted performance is at your fingertips. Elevate your driving experience with a vehicle that's built to impress. Acura of Stockton has a great selection of new Acuras and customer service that will exceed your expectations. And right now, lease a new Acura TLX, MDX, or Integra with low lease rates available. Take luxury to a whole new level in a new Acura from Acura of Stockton and AcuraofStockton.com.
I'm Craig Ashton of the injury law firm of Ashton & Price. Whether you've been injured on a bicycle, as a pedestrian in a slip and fall, auto, Uber, Lyft, or big rig accident, you need Ashton and Price in your corner. When you call Ashton and Price, there's no chatbot telling you to hit 3 for accounting. You're greeted by a real live person who will immediately transfer you to an experienced attorney. The consultation's free, and there's never a fee until you win.
Remember, for the best advice, don't think twice. Call Ashton and Price.
Live and local in the afternoon.
They always keep you on edge.
Cattles.
And Ramie.
On Sactown Sports.
Live from DOCO, Cattles and Ramie on this Wednesday. Happy hump day to everybody out there listening, everybody that's making their way here to the G1C tonight. I mentioned last segment, it seems to be a late arriving crowd because of the heat. So be prepared for that. If you're going to show up a little bit later than usual, you're probably going to be stuck in the crush.
Yes.
So
you'll be standing in the heat anyways.
My advice would be leave immediately.
Get here now.
Head to the G1C right now, because what's going to happen is all of these people are going to leave later than usual. The traffic is going to be outrageous. You're going to left being, you know, you're going to be left parking late, getting here late. It's going to throw your whole night off.
Not to mention every single person is going to stop and grab a rally towel from Bobby.
Yes. So
that's going to slow things down.
Yes.
You know?
Bobby loves handing out them rally towels.
Man's good at it.
Absolutely.
Just tosses them around. Does a little Hulk Hogan.
Absolutely loves it.
Yes, sir.
You know what else we love? We love some Charles Barkley. And the TNT pregame show happening right now. And if you were wondering what Charles Barkley would say about this game tonight, as the cowbells walk by, there we go.
There it is.
If you were wondering what Chuck would say about this game, who does he think is going to win this game? Well, let's hear from Charles Barkley himself.
The Kings gonna whoop their ass tonight.
Ooh.
Guaranteed. Guaranteed.
Really?
And it ain't gonna be close.
Ooh, say it the way you
really
it.
Not gonna be close.
I will say it with your chest then.
The Kings are gonna blow the Warriors out tonight.
And
guaranteed.
Knew it. Knew that was coming.
It's a guarantee.
Knew it.
That the Kings are going to whoop that ass tonight. Guarantee.
Not even close.
And there's only one way we can respond to that, Ramie. We could only hype the crowd up even more with some Mike Brown fast, 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 pace, pace, pace. Let's go.
Sacramento's newest hit.
There we go. Feel it. That's right, get clubbing. What's up, Kings fan? How you doing? You ready tonight? Charles Barkley got his guarantee. Game 5 at G1C. Here at DOCO, Cattles and Ramie. Getting ready. Getting ready for Warriors Kings tonight. Let's go. De'Aaron Fox, avulsion fracture, nothing. Domas Sabonis, avulsion fracture, again.
Don't matter.
Nothing. Kevin Herter struggling? Nothing. Harrison Barnes? Can't throw it in the ocean? Nothing. We're going to figure it out. We are going to figure this
man,
out.
Dude, that song.
It's absolutely
gets
a banger.
Gets me going.
Absolutely
gets me going.
Yoda's
gets
back
the
there.
People going.
Yoda's back there with the rally
chilling.
Towel, the King's hat. I mean, we can't be more ready for this game 5. It's a must. It's a must. And we'll see.
Notice we put Yoda in the shade, by the way.
Yeah, Yoda's getting the shade.
In the sun.
The humans are in the sun. Yoda's getting
yeah,
the shade.
Yeah, keep the baby in the shade, man. You got to take care of him.
50-year-old baby.
He's still a baby. Delicate. Fragile.
All right, so there's a little bit of fast, 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 pace, pace, pace for your face.
Oh, man.
Fantastic stuff. Getting ready.
Really great job by Nate back in the studio.
The crowd is starting to somewhat trickle in.
It's getting
Thank
hype.
You,
somewhat trickle in.
It's getting hype out here.
Meanwhile, just a couple things here. Let's go to the text line, YouTube. YouTube's been fantastic. 216 likes, trying to get to 250 before the end of the show.
We can do that.
YouTube.com, Sactown Sports, 1140. Bobby handing out rally towels. The
Bobby.
Dude on the promotions team, I always forget his name. He's handing out rally towels. Simone is like a politician. She's just walking and
working
talking to everybody.
Crowd,
is that a snakeskin skirt she got on?
Babies.
Is that snakeskin?
It is. It is.
Is that an honor to our snake conversation yesterday? Snake skin skirt on. Making friends all over the place. D Siberia, just call me Purple D up in this female. Dope. I think Jaime. Jaime or Jamie? I'm going to go with Jaime.
I'll go with Jaime.
Jaime says, my dogs, with the exclamation point. I'd make an Usos wrestling joke, but, you know, it wouldn't fly with most of you. Jesse underscore 916, let's go, with a lot of O's. So it's more like, let's go.
Let's go.
Yeah, see the distortion. It's tough. It's tough. Kim says, gentlemen looking good today.
Hey, I was looking at you.
Obviously talking. Can I? JJ's face made my day right there. JJ's looking at you as you're looking at the camera, just thoroughly entertained by that. Thoroughly entertained. That was unbelievable. Thank you, Kim. I'm sure she was talking to JJ, Rami, and Jason Anderson. Gerald Contreras says, first and fourth quarter Fox. That'd be nice. Again,
we'll take that.
I really don't know what to expect from Fox tonight. I'm hoping for the best. You know, they say, like, hope for the best and, like, expect the worst or prepare for the worst.
Yep.
Maybe that's what we should do. We should hope for the best, prepare for the worst, just in case. But, yeah, this is going to be – I said it earlier. This game is going to be a very high-anxiety game. Every time Fox is around traffic, you're, like, taking a deep breath. Every time he goes up to the bucket, you're taking a deep breath.
Yep.
But it does – again, I haven't seen anything telling me that he's not playing tonight. So, the word still at this point is that De'Aaron's going to be on that floor, which does not surprise me one bit. Spirit, competitiveness at an all-time level from this guy. And he's been doing it all year long. He's been doing it all series long.
Oh, what are we doing here? He just gave a Warriors fan. No, don't give him that. Don't give him that.
That's why I don't know his name.
A Warriors fan? A towel? One of the purple rally pals?
That's why I don't know his name. Frankly, he doesn't deserve for me to know his name by doing that.
He really didn't give the kid the towel.
He pulled it away. We just bullied him into not giving the poor kid the towel. That poor kid walked away, head down. Now
I feel bad.
Bobby's going to go chase him down.
The kid was genuinely dejected. Give him a towel. It's just a towel. Who cares?
That was fantastic. That was fantastic.
Give that boy a towel. Come on.
Look. Great competitive spirit from D Fox. Hopefully his production is there. Even if you get 75% of it, we'll take it. We'll love it. But I just can't say enough about him going out there and playing. And same thing with Domas, who's played through an avulsion fracture all year long. These guys, they you know what I love about it? They've backed up what they've said, man. They've told us that they care about winning. They've told us that they love to compete. They've told us that every game, every single second, every single minute matters to them. And they prove it by going out there and playing. And not only playing, but playing their butts off. Look, Domas is not having a good series. But, you know, don't mistake that for a guy who doesn't care or he's not competitive or he's not playing hard. Just not having a good series so far. And that could turn around tonight, and hopefully it does.
And hopefully, Nick, there's an inspiration or a motivation factor that these guys are looking at De'Aaron Fox with his broken finger and going out there and showing up for the game anyways and saying, hey, if he's going to show up for us, we need to show up for him. There's always a human element to this game. And when you talk about team chemistry and guys having each other's back, guys loving each other, being there for each other, I think you might get a little extra juice out of the fact that De'Aaron Fox is going to go out there and play with this injury.
Yeah. Also, Amitrock asks us what happened to Grogu's De'Aaron Fox t-shirt. Hashtag blame Simone. She forgot to appropriately dress baby Yoda today. That's on her.
She was too busy taking all the compliments.
Yeah, she's too busy telling people how big of a deal she is. Distracted by telling people of her greatness.
She's actually complaining during the last break that no one has delivered her coffee yet.
As she sashays around DOCO.
Yes.
Shaking hands, kissing babies.
Yes.
They call me the mayor.
Nobody calls you the mayor. Nobody calls you the mayor.
You know what's funny, fellas? Is you guys don't get to hear the conversations that happen because you got headphones on 90% of the time.
Yeah.
And even though you guys have one headphone off your ear, Simone, like literally three women just walked up to Simone and like, oh, we listen to you guys every day. And then she's like, oh, but you're Simone though, right? And then Simone's like, oh, yeah, that's Ramie and Nick and that's Jay over there.
Cattles and Ramie.
Yeah,
the like, Cattles and Ramie show or whatever.
You're right.
I'm Simone. Yes, that's me.
I like to call them my helpers. Top spots.
Yeah, those are the guys I put on my back and carry every day for 4 hours.
Live from DOCO. It's Cattles and Ramie on a hump day.
Cattles and Ramie.
Sactown Sports. It's the Carmichael Dave Show with Jason Ross.
Whether it be between the third and the fourth or at some point, we got to embrace basketball hell, man. Now that we're a good team, that's a whole different meaning. And again, not trying to sell merchandise for the Kings, but, you know, there's lots of hell merchandise out there.
It would Kings sell. Hell would buy. Sell.
Hell sells. Who's buying?
Yes. Yeah. I think everybody's in.
The Carmichael Dave Show with Jason Ross. Weekday mornings from 6 to 10 on Sactown Sports.
Right now, spring is at the Home Depot, and it's time to get growing. Whether you're planting vegetables or herbs, or just sprucing up your indoor space with lush 6-inch Vigoro Tropicals, we have what you need to get your season started. Visit your local Home Depot Garden Center today and shop our easy-to-grow, bigger, bolder tropicals, like peace lilies, dracaena, or ficus plants. Do your spring at the Home Depot. How doers get more done. Product varies by store.
Serve you. As a family-owned and operated dealership since 2009, customer service is our number one priority. Our customers love doing business with us, and you will too.
Looking to own or lease? During the spring sales event, drive a brand new Accord or Civic. Visit us today at FolsomLakeHonda.com, your one-stop Honda shop.
Folsom Lake Honda, yeah, your one-stop Honda shop.
Warehouse Paint is where the local pros go for all of their paint project needs. Enjoy same-day turnarounds, same-day color matching, color consultation services, and free job site deliveries. With a large in-stock selection of PPG and Benjamin Moore paints and stains, and an expert sales team that is here to help, Warehouse Paint has exactly what you need to complete your next project. Visit warehousepaint.com to find a store near you. That's warehousepaint.com.
Get ready for a night of thrilling punches and knockouts. Saturday, May 27th, Gold Country Casino Resort in Oroville is hosting a live professional boxing event. Watch Segundo Padilla from San Jose face off against Ronald Ron from Los Angeles. We'll also have other exciting bouts lined up for an unforgettable night of thrilling matches that will keep you on the edge of your seat. Get your tickets now at GoldCountryCasino.com.
Gold Country Casino Resort.
Must be 21 or older.
Hey, basketball fans. The playoffs are here, and Sacramento's ready to win it all. And while you're cheering them on, you're going to want a nice, cool home to watch those games in. That's why you should call Fox Family Heating and Air for all of your air conditioning repair needs. With our amazing technicians and lifetime warranty on most repairs, we'll make sure that your home stays cool and comfortable for the playoffs. So come on, beat the buzzer and call Fox Family Heating and Air today.
Fox Family Heating and Air. Get in zone. AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? Ah, starting trouble. No one likes that. We can get you set up for some stronger starts. You might just need a fresh charge, and we can take care of that free of charge. But if it is time for a new battery, we've got replacement batteries that'll fit your needs, starting at just $79.99. That's what makes us America's number one battery destination.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Restrictions apply.
Near the banks of the Sacramento River, Perry Dye of the famous Dye family of golf architects designed Bartley Cavanaugh Golf Course as Sacramento's number one course for fun. Dye's design and mixture of holes assures players of a fun-filled day with friends. Bartley Cavanaugh's moderately sized greens and generous fairway landing areas make for an affordable and fun round of golf. After golf, relax on the outdoor veranda with a cold beverage or a tasty meal. For tee times, visit bartleycavanaugh.com. It's Sacramento's number one course for fun.
Great team, great team. Where's the defense? Defense! Okay, everyone take a break.
Greetings, Sacramento. Doug Christie here for the Good Feet Store, asking when is something too good to be true? When it probably is, and had I not experienced it for myself, this spectacular season would definitely qualify as too good to be true. So everyone out there in radio land, continue to enjoy. Something else that could seem too good to be true is Good Feet Arch Support. But trust me, I've experienced firsthand the comfort, balance, and support possible with Good Feet Arch Support. And so have countless others who have pretty much given up hope. It's time you felt good again. Take your feet to the Good Feet store for a free personalized arch support fitting and test walk. Experience for yourself the comfort, balance, and support missing in your life. The Good Feet store in Sacramento, Roseville, Stockton, Modesto, and now Vacaville, online at goodfeet.com.
KH2KAM HD1 Sacramento, KYMX HD2 Sacramento, the flagship station of your Sacramento Kings.
From the Power Business Technology Toshiba Studios,
this is Sactown Sports. Sactown Sports
Headlines.
It's Simone with your Sactown Sports Headlines. Sacramento Kings get ready for a crucial Game 5 matchup tonight with the Golden State Warriors at Golden 1 Center. Of course, the series remains tied 2-2 as both teams thus far have taken care of business on the home court. The big headline, of course, has been the precarious status of De'Aaron Fox and his fractured index finger on his left shooting hand. We will keep you updated on his status and preview this exciting matchup all afternoon, reporting live outside of G1C, leading you up to game night coverage beginning at 5:30 and tip-off slated for 7 right here on Sactown Sports or on our Sactown Sports app. I'm Simone. Those are your Sactown Sports headlines. Nate, let's toss it down to Cattles and Rami.
Did you miss the headline and the top story of the day?
Extra, extra, we know about it.
Don't worry, because we got you covered.
This is how we do.
It's the Cattles and Rami
Top Spot.
Fourth and final hour of the radio show, actually last 30 minutes or so here live from DOCO outside of the G1C, getting ready for Game 5, Warriors-Kings. And, of course, our first round playoff coverage on Sactown Sports is brought to you by our good friends at National Garage Door. National Garage Door, quality doors, quality people. And, Rami, we start this hour the way we started the show. And De'Aaron Fox, look, there's been all sorts of different reports the last couple of days. You go back to Monday, and we find out that this is an avulsion fracture and that it's at the tip of the index finger of De'Aaron Fox's shooting hand. And immediately the question was, is Fox going to play? Will he be able to play? We thought that he would play. We expected him to be out there tonight. Then yesterday, non-contact practice, Foxy speaks with the media, tells the media that he's 99 to 100% sure that he's going to play and that he feels good. Sam Amick of The Athletic then writes that Fox seemed frustrated yesterday, shooting around after the non-contact practice and was cursing and yelling while he was shooting at times. I'm not worried about that. We talked about it earlier. I think frustration is obvious. He's hurt. He doesn't want to be hurt. I expect him to play tonight and then play through it, Rami. But I don't know. I don't know what we should expect tonight from Fox. I mean, the fact that he's out there, if he is out there, we haven't heard word just yet officially, but if he is out there to play this game tonight, I think Kings fans should take solace in that first and foremost. And then we watch to see how he's reacting, how he's playing through traffic, the handle, the shot, all of those different things. You know, defensively, what is he doing? How's he playing when guys are digging? Is he more apprehensive to go downhill tonight and get to the rim? We'll see as the game plays out, but I have no idea what level of expectation is reasonable. Say 75%, I guess, I hope. And if that is the case, I hope the guys roll tonight and everybody else steps up.
I don't feel as bad about the injury as I did on Monday when we first heard it, Nick. And I literally felt like somebody punched me in the stomach when I opened up
the tweet
from Shams.
Gut shot.
I don't feel as good about it, though, as I did yesterday, just 24 hours ago, after De'Aaron Fox came out and said 99, 100% chance he's going to play. And I do think he's going to play. But just with the story that, you know, he hit his finger on the steering wheel when he was getting in his car.
Yeah.
And that hurt like hell. The fact that that what we didn't hear yesterday about the grimacing while he was shooting and the cursing when he missed a free throw. Do you have news?
I do have news. Sacramento Kings tweeted out injury update.
Oh.
De'Aaron Fox is available.
Hey.
So it's officially official.
There we go.
It's officially official. The glass case of emotion is in full effect over the last couple of days, but literally 20 seconds ago, the Kings tweet out that De'Aaron Fox is available.
Let's go.
De'Aaron Fox is going to play this game tonight. Again, he said yesterday at the practice that he felt like he was going to play. He was 99 to 100% sure, but now we know he's going to be out there. Now we know Fox is going to play, and it's all about how this team adjusts to that, Ramie. It's all about, is Fox going to start? I would think so, because you would think he's going to get a shot in that index finger, and he's not going to feel any better than he's going to feel the first 5 minutes of this game tonight.
For sure. Between the adrenaline, between whatever they jab into that finger, he should be feeling as good to start this game as he had for the last few days, since it swelled up after game four. That is very, very good news, Nick. We expected it, but it feels really good to have it confirmed, De'Aaron Fox available for the Kings tonight.
Yeah.
Five
and our guy Amadrock doing work on the YouTube chat. Can we get to 250? Can we get to 250 likes? Get us to 250 likes just for De'Aaron Fox.
We can do
just
that.
Just for Foxy playing tonight.
For
just
Baby
for him
Yoda?
Being available.
Baby Yoda.
Avulsion fracture means nothing to this guy.
Simone's out there playing somewhere.
Domas. Avulsion fracture means nothing to Domas. Be out there playing tonight. So we'll see how he adjusts. We'll see if this changes his game at all. You know, it's something we haven't really discussed, Ramie. When you look at how the Warriors are going to defend Fox, I do wonder if they're just going to lay off of him and see if he wants to shoot. Like, if I'm the Warriors, I'm staying away. I'm going to give him all sorts of leeway, and I'm going to say, you take that shot. I want to see if you're comfortable taking that shot. I want to see if you're comfortable trying to drive by me. Because the more dribbles that you have to take with that hand gives us more opportunity to dig at you. So I wonder if we're going to see some of that from the Warriors defense where, you know, they're just going to give Fox that shot and say, hey, we'll give you that shot and we'll give Domas the 15-footer like we've been giving him all season.
I know this is going to sound dirty, but Nick, you and I both know this goes on. Domas Sabonis said it earlier in the season when it comes to his hand injury that, you know, guys chopped at it, guys slapped at it, and it seemed like it was intentional, like they were trying to
– yep.
To inflict some harm or some pain onto him. If I'm the Warriors, I think that's what I'm doing, man. I'm getting up in him and I'm slapping, I'm hacking, I'm reaching in, and I'm seeing how he handles that and how that hand handles any sort of incidental contact that may occur while I'm playing some aggressive physical defense. You know what I mean?
I'm interested to see how many minutes he plays. You know, one of the things I didn't get to Jason Anderson with when he joined us earlier, you can check out that interview, sactownsports.com, the podcast page. But one of the things that we did not get to Jason while he was on the Folsom Lake Honda hotline earlier today was, you know, if Fox looks like he's struggling, how much rope is Mike Brown going to give him? And I think that's a compelling question to ask, because look, Fox is going to play. He's going to want to play 35 minutes. He's going to want to play 40 minutes tonight. But if Fox is looking uncomfortable, how much time does Coach Brown give Fox to get, quote unquote, used to the hand before he says, okay, this isn't looking great?
We
if it's not,
plan B.
Yeah, if it's not looking great, okay, we got to pull the trigger on this. We can't have him out there playing 40 minutes tonight. When does Coach Brown make that call, and how does that shuffle the lineup? Obviously, Davion comes in for Fox and he gets most of the minutes, but Malik Monk, I would imagine, also plays some point guard tonight if that was the case. But, you know, how much leeway, how much rope does Coach Brown give his star tonight to try to figure things out?
And no matter how much leeway or how much rope that is, Nick, and no matter how much he can play, no matter how effective he is, that's only going to go so far to beat this Warriors team, man. And it's they need some other guys to step in and contribute. They need Domas to look like regular season Domas. They need Kevin Herter to hit some threes. They need Keegan Murray to sort of pick up where he left off in game four. They need Harrison Barnes to step up and give you a little bit more than he's given you in games one through four. He can't do it himself, broken finger or no broken finger. And no matter what version of De'Aaron Fox you get tonight, some things are going to have to change and get better for this Kings team if they're going to take a 3-2 lead. And, man, they need to take a 3-2 lead, Nick. Whoever wins this game tonight, in my opinion, wins this series.
this weekend. I don't know if it'll take six. I don't know if it'll take seven. But I don't see either of these teams being able to come back and win two straight if they lose game five here tonight. They need these guys to step up and go out there and get this win tonight.
We talked about starting Davion tonight. We'll see if Coach Brown makes any changes to the starting lineup. I do not anticipate, even though I said I would start Davion, I don't anticipate changes. I think Coach Brown is going to stick with what got these guys here. And to your point, Ramie, and we also got a text saying this at 916-339-1140. You know, Herter hasn't found his rhythm. Taking him out of the starting five could even further impact that rhythm. I could argue, I could counter and say, well, you know, him coming off the bench might take a little bit of that pressure off and all that, and maybe he can jump into the game and feel a little bit better about himself. But I do not, with all that said, with Davion starting now, I do not expect Coach Brown to change anything tonight. I really don't. I think you'll see what you've seen through the first four games. Because if you're Coach Brown, game three was the anomaly, right? That was the Kings not playing their game, not really showing up that well for that first game in San Francisco. I think feeding into the narrative, as we talked about post game three. But games one, two, and four, man, nip and tuck. And so, you know, Coach Brown might look at it and say, I don't think I need to make a dramatic change when these games are tight.
Yeah, no, I get where you're coming from with starting Davion Mitchell, but I don't see it happening. Now, as this series gets deeper, Nick, and the stakes get higher and the clock keeps on ticking towards, you know, a potential loss in the series and going home for the offseason, I think Mike Brown's leash gets a little bit shorter with all these guys. If Kevin Herter ain't shooting the ball well, we talked about going to plan B with De'Aaron Fox if the finger doesn't allow him to play effectively. I think Mike Brown has a plan B for if Kevin Herter isn't hitting his shots, for if Keegan Murray isn't hitting his shots, for if Harrison Barnes isn't hitting his shots. But there's only so many default plans that you can come up with at the end of the day.
Right.
I think he needs at least two of those three guys that I just mentioned to wake up offensively and contribute for this Kings team between Barnes, Herter, and Murray. Two of those three guys gotta perform for you consistently.
And frankly, if you're Coach Brown, you know, the truth is you have only so many bullets. We've talked about that, right? Like, I think this team, if they had one more 3-and-D wing, I think they'd be in a great position as far as depth goes. I think they're missing, like, at least that one guy, right? That one guy. Len's been able to give you some of those minutes at the backup five. But you only have so many options. So, you know, maybe if you go down 3-2 in game six, maybe you say, all right, this is when we push that button and we make the change, whatever that change is. But for now, you're going to keep it the way it is, right? You're gonna do what you do and see if your guys can just play better, you know, HB, Herter, and the others. By the way, Scooter916 says it's warm out here in the sun. I feel Rami's pain.
Yeah. No, I'm standing in the shade the rest of the show.
It's a little moist out here.
Can't do it.
It's a little bit moist.
I got a comedy show tonight at Punchline. Got to stay fresh.
There it is.
8 o'clock, me and Lance Woods.
That's only like your second plug of the day.
Come check it out. I mean, I know what I'm up against, man. You know?
I expected at least a...
Kings are playing. I get it.
I expected at least a plug like once every couple segments. Yeah, at least. By the way, speaking of plugs,
let me make up for it. Punchline tonight, me and Lance Woods, 8 o'clock. Check it out.
KNCI Country in the Park is happening next week. That's right. Head to SactownSports.com right now. You can buy your tickets for KNCI's Jiffy Lube Country in the Park on May 5th and 6th at the Cal Expo. Performances by Chris Young, Lady A, Justin Moore, Brett Eldridge, and more. Tickets are just $45. Weekend passes just $80. And they are available on the SactownSports.com event page.
I don't know about you, Nick. I like a good, like, obscure, random jersey, which you get out at things like this. I just saw a Lawrence Funderburk jersey. That was rocking.
That's fantastic.
It, proudly.
By the way, shout out to Imadrock, has a great idea. He says we need a portable mister.
Oh, yeah.
God almighty, that's a great idea.
That'd be great.
That is a great
idea.
One
of those little fans that missed you? Oh, that'd be outstanding.
Maybe if Simone asks for one, we'll have one by Friday.
Oh, we'd have one out here before the end of the show.
All right, can we get to 250 likes?
Yes, we can.
We're at 237. 13 more likes.
Oh, YouTube. That's light work. Come on, people.
YouTube.com.
You're out here cooking in the sun. You can give us a like.
Baby Yoda's with us hanging out. We will continue from DOCO as we prepare to get you ready for game night, and then we'll have the pregame, then we'll have the game, and then we'll have the postgame. That's how
Bobby's
these things work.
Not the throwing arm.
Chris Watkins.
Tossing towels out to people.
Chris Watkins, by the way, doing the post game show on YouTube. So you want to check that out as well.
Yes, sir.
All right, we'll have our final thoughts on Game 5 coming up in 90 seconds.
Cattles
and Ramie.
Source. Are you ready to hear this on Sactown Sports?
Hand off McCaffrey. Touchdown! San Francisco!
Or how about this?
Feel super, baby!
Feels great,
baby! Five-time Super Bowl champions, and they're looking for number 6.
Catch every Niners game during the 2023 season.
On your home for the 49ers.
Sactown Sports.
Hey, Scott, you look great.
Yeah, I'm feeling good and have a new job.
No, there's something different about the way you look.
To be honest, a few months ago, I had an amazing robotic hair transplant procedure at XL Medicine. It's called the artist procedure.
No way. Your hair looks completely natural, and you don't even have a scar. How did they do that?
Dude, the artist system is amazing. I have this fantastic hairline, and I'm happy with my results. XL Medicine could probably help you too, buddy.
Using the artist procedure, Dr. Singh and Dr. Graywall can target and harvest healthy hair follicles with micron-level accuracy from the back of your head and transplant them where you need it. The procedure is painless, and you'll be back doing your regular activities in a couple of days. Ask Dr. Singh and Dr. Graywall at XL Medicine about the artist procedure. Call today, 916-932-4470. That's 932-4470 for a complimentary in-person or Zoom consultation. Or on the web at xlmedicine.com. That's EXCELmedicine.com. See what the artist procedure can do for you.
These are actors and not real patients.
Nate Littlefield here with Cattles and Ramie. I just want to give a little update. We are having a little technical difficulty here at DOCO. But I can give a little score update for what's going on in the NBA right now in the Lakers-Memphis game. We got the Memphis is leading by 12 right now, 31-43. But I think we got Nick and Ramie back. Are you guys back?
Yeah, man.
All right.
I was just holding
the crowd over.
Holding the fort down.
Yeah, I'm sorry to cut off your electric update there, but we're ready to go. We are ready to go. Ready to wrap things up here before we get to game night tonight here on Sactown Sports. 11:40 again. Thanks to everybody who has joined this party today.
We had 250. Oh, 247. Come on, people.
You guys have been absolutely terrific today in the YouTube chat. We didn't get to all the calls. Honestly, when we're on the road, sometimes it's tough to get to the calls.
It's hard.
Behind the curtain, there's some logistics at
times.
Need
one more like, Nick. One more like.
We're gonna get there. 250 likes. We're gonna get there. All right, Ramie. Let's jump into this now. The final preview here for Game 5. We're at DOCO outside of G1C. Cattles and Ramie on a Wednesday. Happy hump day to everybody. Look, this to me is a must-win game. You want to win tonight. You do not want to go back to San Francisco down 3-2. You got to take care of business at home. The Warriors have stunk on the road. De'Aaron Fox is going to play through this injury. I would imagine that's going to motivate the guys. Look, the first thing I'll say, Ramie, is this. If the Sacramento Kings do not come flying out of the gates tonight like they're shot out of a cannon for De'Aaron Fox playing, for Domas playing all year long.
Yep.
This series is tied 2-2.
Yep.
This home crowd that's been waiting for 16 years to watch a playoff series, salivating at the idea of moving on to a second round. I would be shocked if the Kings do not come out tonight with all of the energy and urgency that this game deserves.
Not to mention, Nick, the jolt that they should get from this Golden 1 Center crowd tonight, which you can hear start to get riled up out here as they get ready to open the doors. And we broadcast live just outside the northwest entrance of the Golden 1 Center. People are fired up, Nick Cattles. They are ready to get this thing going. I see they're practicing the light show and the lasers inside the arena. The people are ready for this. If the Kings don't react to this, if this doesn't give them a little extra juice, a little extra motivation, on top of De'Aaron Fox and Domas Sabonis, their two best players playing with broken fingers, going out there and leave it all out on the court, I don't know what does. I really just don't know what does. They got to go out and get this win tonight.
Here's what I want to see. I want to see Game 2 Domas. Game 2 Domas came out here at the G1C, and he took it to Kevon Looney, and he took it to this Warriors interior defense. He was much more aggressive than we've seen. I want to see Domas take that 15-footer. I want to see him. I want to see him attack through the chest. I don't want to see the 4-5 turnovers, right? I want to see that aggression from Domantas Sabonis tonight. I would love to see some pick and roll with Domas in the action. I said that earlier, some 1-5 pick and roll with Domas involved. I'd love to see some inverse screens, have the guards and the wings do some screening for Domas to give him some freedom of movement without the basketball to take it to the hoop and make the catch and go right up with it. So I need to see game two Domas. You've played four games now. You know what they're doing to you. You have the intel. It is now your responsibility to react and do what you do best, and that is play in the paint, facilitate the offense, and rebound, and don't turn the ball over.
I don't even know if game two Domas is good enough, Nick.
He did have 24 points. I'll take 24 points for Domas tonight.
Yeah, it wasn't regular season.
260 Domas. Likes, by the way. Let's go.
There we go. I love you people. Thank you. We appreciate you. 260. That's a big day for us here on the Cattles and Ramie show. Part of this is eye test, Nick. I haven't seen Domas go out and have just a Domas game. You know what I mean? Game two was good. I haven't seen him go out and just dominate a basketball game or even have one of those games where we turn around and we're like, oh, damn, he's got a triple-double. I didn't even notice. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
One of those types of nights. And it's just all that much more important when we don't know what we're going to get from De'Aaron Fox, that guy shows up tonight. Nick, there were times throughout the season where he was your best player. Like, De'Aaron Fox has been the best player in the playoffs, but there were plenty of stretches during the regular season. I can't – at least three or four times we asked who's the MVP of this Kings team, and that's because those two guys kept going back and forth in terms of putting the team on their back and carrying them for stretches.
No doubt.
De'Aaron Fox could really use – this whole team could really use a Domas night tonight.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
One of those types of games. That would go a long way – and grabbing a 3-2 lead in this series.
And, you know, you would hope, as you mentioned, you know, with Fox's situation, we don't know what he's going to look like. We don't know how comfortable he's going to be. So the other guys, man, you got to step up. Herter has to step up. He's going to make some shots. I mean, how great would it be tonight to have Herter come out and hit his first couple of jumpers? How great would it be if we see Herter come out, DHO action, knock down the first three? How great would it be to see, I said this earlier in the show when we talked about Harrison Barnes, how great would it be to see an aggressive HB right from the jump, taking the ball to the bucket, getting to the free throw line, not being passive, taking advantage of the mismatches on the switches. Let's see that HB. Let's see the aggressive attacking Harrison Barnes in the first quarter. Get to that free throw line. Make them pay for it. If Steph Curry switches on you or Klay Thompson switches on you or Jordan Poole switches on you, go to work. Go to work, HB. Be aggressive and take advantage of those mismatches.
Yeah, man. They need those guys to step up tonight. This has to be a team effort. And I don't know about you, Nick. I feel pretty good about their chances tonight. I'm not going to go quite as far as Charles Barkley, who said they're going to – what do you say? They're going to –
Guaranteed an ass whooping,
a blowout in this one. But I feel pretty good about their chances tonight of coming out of here with the win. I'm sticking with my prediction of Kings in six. Therefore, I must predict, if that's going to happen, Nick, I must predict that they're going to win this game out here tonight at the Golden One Center.
I want to see also a big night. I want to see a big night from Monk and Davion. I'd like to see that too. And look, Davion, he doesn't have to score 15 points. I want to see a controlled game from Davion. He's been good in this series, if not really good. I'd like to see Monk. I want to see good Monk tonight. I don't want to see bad Monk. I don't want to see the full Monk.
We can't see the full Monk.
No
tonight.
Full Monk tonight.
No, we can't.
No,
we can't
roller coaster
it.
Full Monk.
Can't have it.
We need nothing but good Monk tonight. We get bad Monk, I'm going to be angry. So let's get good Monk tonight. Let's wrap
go.
This show up with some notes.
Let's go.
1/6 fix. Here for Simone and Simone only.
Okay.
Amid Rock.
Did you hear the guy who walked by a minute ago and said, take your freaking shirt off?
No.
And he's talking to me, by the way.
Amid Rock. Behind every great king, there's a queen. Simone is our queen. Danger Man 64, Queen, not Mayor of DOCO.
What are we doing here, people?
Monty making Mitch, Simone's world, we all just live here.
What are we doing?
Creating a monster is what we're doing. I can't hear anything right now, Nate,
it's
if you're playing music.
It's the Simone show with Cattles and Ramie.
So I want to thank.
Is what this has become.
I want to thank Simone. For
and,
being the,
and only Simone.
For being the Cattles and Ramie politician out here shaking hands and kissing babies. Simone did a great job. JJ, fantastic work.
The king is back
the
out
king
here.
Is back. King is back. Said hello.
Appreciate you, sir.
JJ, great job. Nate back in the studio, great job. Rami, I give you a C-.
Thank you.
C- for
I'll
you today.
I'll take that. Tonight, Punchline, me and Lance Woods, 8 o'clock. Check it out.
Tonight, Kings game 5. We're back tomorrow.
Pause it. Come back. Finish it later.
Live at DOCO, outside the G1C. Let's go, Kings. Let's make it happen. Let's bring back that W, Cattles and Rami.
Let's go.
Pass.